As he falls back deeper into a state, the return.
Back to cheese, baby.
That's my mind is speeding by, I'm holding on. Asking God to help, but are you with me? Girl is telling me she don't know what she want. Lot of demons creeping up the living underneath. Gotta take a minute, y'all travel far. Feeling something, no, I can't ignore my instincts. Back just where I started, it's the same old damn song. It's I need. Trying to find it on the right track. Oh, wanna be just for the free act. Tough to hear me, don't speak back. Can't do something in the third act. Lord, seeing me swerve. Do this to my loved ones, I've got some nerve. Don't think I'm not sorry.
Hear me now, hey, this time I'm ready for it. Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me, me, me. Hear me now, hey, this time I'm ready for it. Despite this war in me, despite this war in me, me, me.
I'm here before, I'm here before.
Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me, me, me.
As the story goes, hey, hey, as the story goes.
Despite this war in me, despite this war in me, me, me.
Standing on the cliff right off a Holland Drive. Back on my mind, this is a remedy. Something about the night that keep me safe and warm. Just me, the universe, and everything I think.
Gotta put this wind on me, it's a storm.
Never thought I would be back here bleeding. I'm not just some sad dude. You can see my life, how I grew. I want serenity.
Trying to find it on the right track. Oh, I wanna be just for the fiat. Talk to me, don't speak back. Can't lose, I'm in the third act.
See, it seems I'll never learn. I won't stop till I crash and burn.
Tell my mom I'm sorry. Hear me now, hey, this time I'm ready for it. Can't stop this war in me, can't stop this war in me, me, me. Hear me now, hey, this time I'm ready for it. Despite this war in me.
Are we really betting NIT? Like, is that what we're doing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really?
Of course.
NIT's electric.
Yeah, you bet spring training and fucking darts, but you're drawing the line in the NIT, man. I want to hear shit.
First game of the season, you're telling me you got a hole in your glove? What are you using, your fucking grandpa's mitt from World War II? What are we doing? You're Jake Cronenworth. You're a millionaire. That glove looks like it's been through hell and back. Let's get you a new glove for the season, brother. You had all offseason to break that shit in. How about a rare A-team patch?
Rare. A-team stock is kind of soaring lately.
Okay, recently, in recent weeks, Trevon, A-team stock up, B-team stock
kind of back.
I mean, yeah, I think we just square up for Kitch. Don't overthink it. Take the Shohei and Luka lesson, go about your day. There's no way that fucking ends.
Yeah, fair enough.
Do you have any squad ride plays you need in there? I didn't hear shit. He's like, I feel like I'm talking to a guy on Mars right now. What is going on, chat? Happy BTL Wednesday, episode 435 piece. As always, Hold the Fry, joined by your two hosts, Krabs and Javon, presented by Pickett Sports. If you guys aren't tracking your bets on Pickett, what are you waiting for? What are you doing? Start tracking your bets now. Use promo code Javon and start holding yourselves accountable, figuring out how many units you're up or down. It's not too late. All right, start the year 2024, tracking your bets, figure it out, be a grown-up, hold yourselves accountable, track your bets on Pickett. All right, the link is right here. Use promo code Chelly, promo code Javon, whatever you need to use. Go check out Pickett's fire updates all the time. Okay, people forget you can check stats as well on there. Nobody talks about that. People forget about that. You can check the stats, check the data. All right, the UX is clean. Devin knows. Go check out Pickett's. I promise once you download it, it's free. You're not going to stop using it. It's fire. Okay. We got BWA Bets coming in hot with a resub. One more sleep until baseball. Let's go, BWA Bets. Sure we can. Love that. Javon, how we feeling? About 24 hours out from MLB. I believe the game start at like 4 p.m. Eastern, and they go all through the night. So are you stoked? Are you nervous? How are we feeling about one day out from MLB?
So hyped, dude. Can't wait to see some or start sweating some bets on the diamond. It's going to be absolutely electric. So I'm in.
It's going to be lit. All right. We got 1 p.m. Eastern game. Sure. Orioles are officially sold. W's. Okay. Need a season-long entry. Good thing we are doing that today, Justin. W's. Will Benson, half bases, will feed families for generations to come. W's. Okay.
Yeah, go ahead, I'm sure that'll hit. Go ahead and lock me in for that POD tomorrow.
I'm sure that'll hit. Yep. I'm sure that'll hit. Gosh, man, I'm stoked. All right, we've got a lot to talk about today. We're going to go over the L recaps from yesterday once again. I can't believe we're on this cold of a streak. Ay, ay, ay. 0-0 after one, huh?
Yeah, 1-1 after two, 4 in the second or third.
I think it was 2-1, I believe.
Yeah, it was 2-1. They scored right before the second period ended. So, yeah, 2-1.
Max, can we please hit a squad ride? Can we please hit a squad ride today? Please. Okay. I'm on the same page as you, brother. Same page as you. Let's smack one today. Let's cut the shits. We got to hit a squad ride. It's been too long. All right. Sharp report recap. L's all across the place. All right. I had 3 losses. You had 2 and a push. Sure. Bruins were free. Mavs were free. Even with the weird Luka news, did not matter. W's there. The Flyers were free. +1.5. Good thing you grabbed the points. I took that as well with you. Good play. We'll take it. Good thing we didn't take the ML. We would have been in so much piss. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Gosh, man. Javon, thoughts, comments, concerns on the Sharp report?
I don't know. We're just dragging along with this weird little hangover couple days of slates until baseball, especially today. Like, we're pretty much just NBA and 2 hockey games and then a little sprinkle of CBB. So it's kind of difficult to navigate, but we got to do it. That's what we're here for.
Has to be done. All right. I wouldn't want to deal with anyone else. I think we can handle it today. All right. We've got NIT. We've got CBI. We've got NBA, NHL, MLB tomorrow. Plenty on the slate to attack. We might as well go ahead and cut the shit and dive into the Sharp report. But first, going to need a bitch about something. All right. We can't just hop right into this puppy without complaining about some shit. Goods, we have a minute. We got 30 seconds. I got to complain. Keeps getting worse, doesn't it, huh? Just keeps getting worse. Rumor has it on Hokie Twitter, there are a lot of other moves to come. This is not the only one, but this is the only one that matters. Man, that one stung a little bit. That one stung a little bit. Gosh, man, the only cool piece we had coming back next year, gone. Smell you later. He'll be going to Oklahoma or some shit like that. He's from there. Much better team, much better situation. I'll be rooting for Padula. Okay. Chalk the program. It's caked. VT men's and women's absolutely in piss right now. I mean, the women's team was electric and, you know, our best player's knee explodes a week before the tournament and our coach leaves to go to Kentucky, I bet. And then Sean Padula the day after the season ends or whatever, the week after the season ends, he's out of here. There he goes. See ya. This sucks. No other way to put it. Did not even want to spend time putting up the Lynn Kidd transferring, hitting the portal graphic, because that doesn't mean shit. I'm blown though. I'm blown. I really enjoy Padula. I enjoy watching him play. I know he's very turnover prone. I know he's very ball hoggish, but he was the one who kept us in a lot of these games and put on some crazy performances. So smell you later, Padula. We will be seeing. I swear to God, if he ends up going to somewhere, you know, in the ACC, I'm going to explode. And if we end up getting JJ McCarthy coming up, it's just going to be another, you know, piece of piss along the roads at this point, because there's been so much. Being a Hokie fan is hard. Being a Hokie fan sucks. Another fucking reason to bitch and complain. And Sean Padula, our only good player coming back next year, he's gone. Javon, I know you don't give a hoot. Any thoughts on our guy, Sean Padula?
Yeah, probably welcome to the Big 12, brother.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's going to end up. He might have gone to Oak State. It's kind of the vibe I'm getting. It's going to be a poke. They need some transfers in there too. But, yeah, VT gun and piss. Might have to be a football school now.
Yeah. I mean, good thing our football team is looking pretty sharp. Apparently, our QB, Kyron Jones, is hanging out a lot with Shador Sanders this offseason, going out in Florida, clubbing.
Yeah. He's good, right?
Two goats. Gosh, man. Padula, you are a Kentucky Wildcat. Sure. These tweets were geeking me. You guys were replying on Twitter to me. Sean, you are a Oklahoma Sooner. Those shits were geeking me, bro. Man. JJ and Padula out. I bet. Couldn't ask for any more, KJ. KD. Could not ask for any more. Oi. Brutal. Yep. We move. We groove. It is what it is. Let's get this shit off the screen. I do have something that was pretty brutal that we all saw today, this morning. Might as well talk about it. Our guy here, Charlie Baker, a.k.a. the biggest narc on earth, trying to ban college prop bets. You know, this is more just to save face. I feel like a lot of these kids have been bitching about people in their DMs. People bitching about, I don't know. Wait, what? Terry McLaurin arrested? No.
No shot.
No. Timeout. Timeout. Because either the craziest thing just happened or this guy's getting banned.
Cap. Venom.
Cap, Ben, Mods, get him out of here. We don't have time for that. Get him out of here. Get him out. Not kidding. All right. Charlie Baker, biggest narc on earth, trying to ban college props. This is beat. Look, I mean, they're trying to save face. You got kids bitching about people complaining to them on the court. You got people bitching about them in their DMs. So to anybody who's, you know, DMing players, telling them to go fuck themselves, you guys ruined it. Thanks. Really appreciate that. Great. This is pretty much just a safe face, right? The props, the player props for college basketball, for college sports, only bring in about 1.5% of all the action. So it's not like the books even really give a shit. This is more just for college sports to come in and say, hey, we're trying to do everything we can to keep these players safe and not have this get out of control. But it actually really doesn't do shit. I think this is useless. They're trying to save face. And all this does is fuck over guys like us who make a living out of this shit. Beat.
Yeah, it's stupid. It is. If I can't take some props for some college football games on the weekend, I'm going to be in moose. I mean, it's only part of it, but yeah, that sucks. They better not.
You know, maybe Jose Perez had something to do with it. I don't know.
It could have been. That might have been Jose Perez. Bitching.
It could have been. It is what it is. Worried about prop betting when Utah women's team is getting harassed. Yeah, I bet NCAA. Yeah, that shit was whack too. Gosh, man, NIL is fine, but no props. Yeah, I mean, I just don't get it. I did make Perez better. That's what I do. I make people around me better, okay? Push them to their limits. He should be grateful. Does he have another year of eligibility? There's no way.
No, I said he was working on his professional career.
Yeah.
Professional opportunities.
I mean, he could go play overseas.
Yeah, I mean, he might have to.
Yeah. Can't have nice things, chats.
With European coaching, he'll be in piss. He's not. He won't work out over there.
Yeah, he might be in piss.
He can't even
come. Pat Kelsey.
Yeah, that was wild.
You guys hear this shit?
Yeah.
Pat Kelsey going to fucking, or is he going to Louisville?
Nuts. Yeah.
Nuts. Good for him. Right? One of the best mid-major coaches in college basketball. One coach of the year once again in this conference. So, Pat Kelsey, a goat. From College of Charleston, okay? Happy for him. What am I supposed to do if they ban college props? I don't know, B-Camp. I don't know. Super B. Man. I really hope this is all bullshit and they're just talking to make it seem like they're trying to do stuff for the students and players and keep them safe. But it sounds like they're probably going to find a way to ban these college props. So we'll see how it plays out. Let's hope this doesn't pan out, right? But I wouldn't be surprised with how little handle and bets these books get on the college props. I wouldn't be surprised if they say, you know what, fuck it, we'll just get rid of them for you guys, make you happy. That would stink. That would stink. We'll see how it plays out. All right? W's, yeah, all this is going to do is make people go back to using bookies. So it's stupid. If people want to bet college props, they'll be able to bet them. All this does is make it more unsafe. Stupid. Stupid. All right? Let's hop into the BTL Sharp Report. Javon, we got shit to do. All right, we got a hype train moving and grooving level 2. We've got 10 plays, 10 winners for today's slate. We're going to go over these plays. We're going to go over the MLB BTL season-long Megalodon. We're going to craft that puppy up live right on here. Okay? So stick with us, chat. We've got a lot to do. Tempo and pace. Very important today. Very important. Javon, I'll get it started out the only way we really should, with some CBI championship action on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon. Not even night. Afternoon. 5 p.m. Eastern start. 4 p.m. your time, Javon. This puppy is going to be here soon. We got Seattle getting a line flip as well, opening up +1. now -1.5 on the ML against High Point. High Point was barely able to pull off a win last night against Arkansas State. Shout out Arkansas State for covering. Love that. W's, free, air. I'll tell you what, High Point was running out of steam in that game. You could tell. They were fucking gassed, and now they got to play another game today. I'm going to go with Seattle in this spot with this line flip, Javon. Significantly worse team that has been playing much better towards the end of the season. Seattle really got hot down the stretch, and they're playing some really good basketball right now. They just destroyed a Fairfield team. Their defense has been nails of late. I think High Point is too gassed right now. They like to run a little bit, push the tempo. I don't think they're going to be able to do it against Seattle. Seattle doesn't want to do it. The Seattle team looks great right now, playing their best ball of the season. The line's flipping. I'm going to back the Seattle boys on the ML today in the CBI championship.
It's an interesting one. I don't hate that. I don't hate that at all. To be in.
Sure. Take me to the ice. What do we like about Ottawa?
Yeah, I mean, there's two games on the ice today. One of them is a really, really great game, and the Lightning and Bruins that, to be honest, I don't know what to do with. And it's also a pick 'em, so short slate, toss-up matchup, one of the handful of teams that I kind of just don't overthink it and go for the dog in high-variance games. It's between the Sens, you know, the Kraken, the Flames sometimes, the Caps, all these teams that are involved. The Sens are involved in this one, and it's not just for the fact that that's the case, but I kind of like them in this game too. The Sabres, usually they're a team that gets a lot of line respect at home. And I know the Sens are not on like the craziest slide either, but the Sabres have been playing pretty well. I think the line is a little short. Plus, this is a matchup that did recently just happen. Came away with the Sabres win ever so slightly, but they're also coming home off of a really long road trip, which has been one of the more profitable spots to fade in the NHL really for the last couple of years, but especially the last two, including this one. So the Sens are coming back. This is going to be a weird game too. Like UPL is so hit or miss in net, and he's been definitely more hit than miss as the Sabres have been surging a little bit for the playoffs in the last couple of weeks here. It's just one of those games that I think the Sens get up for. They can take the Sabres up and down the ice, skate with pace, make them a little uncomfortable. So I was definitely expecting a little more respect here for the Sabres. So like they're always fake sharp at home against these really, really good teams. So like, they've been in spots where they're super short underdogs or even like slight favorites when they shouldn't be. And now I think it's weird to see the Sens on the road getting as much respect as they are. So I'm taking them today for a couple of reasons. That's one.
All right. Only a couple hockey plays today. That does not matter. Javon found a winner for the squad. Ottawa ML. Love it. I got a little two-piece parlay, a little basketball parlay. You want to hear about it?
Sure.
Sure. Seton Hall on the ML, moving up from, I believe, -6.5 to -8.5 is what I'm seeing right now. Sorry, -3.5 to -6 is what we're getting there on that crazy line movement. Good look for Seton Hall, in my opinion, against a UNLV team playing really good down the stretch. We know what the Rebels do. They play defense. They play great in the first 10 minutes of the game, and then they kind of slowly fade, but they've been able to hold on to games in this NIT tournament down the stretch, playing really well. They even got their first postseason win in over 20 years in the NIT. So this tournament is very important for this Rebels team, I will say. And they've got young guys like Dean Thomas who are out there still trying to play great. I'll be honest with you, though, this line movement's enough for me to fade this UNLV squad. I'll tell you what, Seton Hall, looking at their squad, they're playing great right now, too. They're dominating, destroying every squad they play. They look like the one seed in the NIT. They look like a team that should have been in March Madness, and they're playing like it. They're playing out of their minds. And this team is playing like a squad that wants to prove to everybody that they belonged in the March Madness tourney and not in the NIT. Okay, they're not done yet. They're playing out of their minds. They've got way too many guards, in my opinion, for this UNLV team to cover. I know their defense is pretty solid. They have a good defense on the interior, but Jaden Bediako should be able to do enough, at least to be competitive against Whaley and Co. down there. And they've got three insane guards in Richmond, Dre Davis, and Dawes, who are going to be uncoverable for this UNLV, these UNLV guards. How are they going to keep up with all three of those guys? I don't know. Seton Hall's playing out of their fucking minds. That's probably why they're catching the steam. It's UNLV's time to lose. I hate to say it. I would love to keep back in this team. They've been a great story in the postseason, but party's over. All right. Seton Hall, dominance, looking great. Best team in the NIT. They're playing like it, catching steam. They win this game. Back them on the ML. And we're going to go ahead and parlay them with the Clippers on the ML, coming off a couple losses on the road. Laying 5.5, and I see you like that play as well. So W's, I'm going to go ahead and take a little shortcut, do a little two-piece ML parlay at -105, but Javon's got the spread. He's not afraid of those points.
Yeah, I'm going to take the spread, which is getting a little bit of steam for better or for worse. We'll see if it's news related, but I don't really think so because it's not up that fat. But this is a revenge game, obviously, for a couple different reasons. First, you have what happened, I think, a little under a week ago. They played in Los Angeles, and the Sixers came out, and they looked like the greatest team of all time. They shot like 50% nearly from three. That includes, you know, 5 for 10 on like 23 points for campaign coming off the bench. So nearly to say, or not crazy to say, that's probably not sustainable and going to happen again. But you also do have the hard return to Philly in this game. So like as squares that may be to use that angle for the game and or Harden props today, finding Harden motivation spots is not very difficult. And I've done it quite a few times, backing him off of a bad game or in a matchup where you kind of think he's going to try a little bit harder. So they're going to throw a lot of pressure at Kawhi. That's kind of how they play defense. So Harden's just going to go one-on-one against a lot of that team. And I think that works for them. So I think he has a really big game, not crazy to say, but I do think they get their little vengeance for getting blown out on their home floor a couple days ago by the same team who, like, I don't think they're going to go out there and shoot 50% from three again. The entire starting lineup had a three in that game, including Mo Bamba. And then obviously you have the campaign legacy performance off the bench. I think it's going to be a little different today, which is why the line is where it is and moving the Clippers way.
I'm in. Love the sell job. Clippers, maybe there's some injury stuff. Hopefully not. Hopefully they're just catching steam, right? Because them laying 5.5 in that spot is a good sign for us on that spread. W sell job. I agree with I will here. Javon will be back. He's okay. Westbrook, second game back, and Ty Lue said the Clippers' identity is they're soft. Wow. Wow. Two words. Wow. Let's keep moving and grooving here. I'm going to talk about the Bulls because they're disgusting. +2.5 on Chicago today on the spreads. I'm loving this bet. I'm loving this bet. Look, guys, it's not for the faint of hearts. They're playing the Pacers, who are a much better team. But why is this Bulls squad only getting 2.5 points? I'm looking at the injury reports. I'm not seeing shit about any of the stars on the Pacers being out in this contest. I'm not really sure why the heck the Bulls are barely getting any points. And neither of these teams are coming off the back-to-backs. The Bulls have even lost their last three games and not even covered them. And it hasn't even been close back. W's. Talking about the Bulls.
Yeah.
On the spread. And why they're so short right now, Javon. I don't get it. The Bulls have beaten the Pacers two of the last three times they played them, right? But the Pacers have won and covered three of their last four games, including a nice outright win at the Clippers, where they destroyed them as dogs outright in their last contest. The Bulls, like I said, they've lost three straight games in a row. They just lost to the Wizards as -13 favorites, Javon. Anytime you lose to the Wizards, it's got to be a little bit of a reality check here, right? These guys got to look themselves in a mirror and say, hey, what the fuck are we doing? All right. Take the Bulls, take the spread, grab the couple points. We might need them. You never know. That spread is hilariously short against the Pacers.
Yeah, that is easily the most suspicious looking line, I would say, on the slate today. So I will gladly get involved with the Bulls with you there.
Okay, let's go. Good. Take me to the Nets. Another nasty play.
Yeah, I mean, not really, because, I mean, it's a play against the Wizards, who, I mean, they've looked great the last couple of games. They're won three in a row. So if they win today and somehow upset the Nets, that's a crazy winning streak for the Wizards. And DeGen is coming in here sweating their under win total every day, might be in a little bit of piss sweating that at the end. But, yeah, this is a play like the Clippers – or not the Clippers, the Wizards, we all know what they're – physical makeup is like they're very perimeter based, pretty soft on the inside, even with Rashawn Holmes in there now instead of playing like the consistent like stretch five with Kuzma down there. And the Nets are quite the opposite. Like they're going to make you funnel to the rim. They're going to be very different. They're going to be super physical. And I think that's a big matchup problem for, you know, the Wizards in this game. And I definitely want to fade and say, you know, there's probably no way the Wizards went four in a row. Call it simple, call it what you want. But I think against a physical team, that's probably not the spot for the Wizards to get that done. So I think they're going to struggle a little bit here trying to generate, you know, consistent offense against this Nets team. I think it'll be tough.
We got DeGen dropping a 5U sub whale for the people. It's good, DeGen.
Sure. Probably likes – he was spawned at the Nets mention, hoping the Wizards drop a game.
I mean, I'm with you. I wanted to ask you about that game. I almost put that bet on my sharp report myself. I mean, it's pretty crazy seeing them as a favorite on the road in Washington, I guess, with the Wizards coming off of three wins. But still the Wizards, right? Yeah,
you can't really make them a
favorite.
Probably
the worst team in the NBA. So
yeah, for what it's worth, I mean, last time they did play, they were plus six, also in Washington, and won outright. So I don't really know what else you're going to put them at.
Yeah, I don't know either. I don't know. I thought that was some respect for the Nets, though, with the Wizards on the still win streak at home. Maybe a little bit.
Maybe a little bit.
All right. People in chat are asking about the Lakers. A lot of Lakers fading love today. A lot of people want to fade the Lakers. I'm with you guys on Memphis, right? My only issue, all right, I would not be shocked because that spread has come down and nobody knows why. LeBron sat out last night. He's probably going to play tonight, right? It's got to be AD. AD's got to be sitting out tonight. They got to be resting him on the second game of a back-to-back. It probably has not come out yet to the public. But the fact that spread has come down a little bit, it's the only thing I can think of. So until I hear any sort of AD injury reports, or maybe they're resting him before the game, I don't know. I'm going to sit back and wait because there's no fucking way that spread is moving without AD sitting out the second game of a back-to-back.
It's possible, but I mean, it would be kind of funny if this was the story. But last night, all I saw was propaganda about how AD, like, his goal was to play 82 games this season. And like, all the tweets are coming about, it's like, you were laughing then, he's been played X amount of the last crazy games or whatever it is. So like, he talked about it in like his post game interview too. So if you were to sit today, that would be very funny looking at, you know, how he just talked about it.
Well, if he plays today and the spread is that short, I will definitely be on Memphis. After the Lakers and Austin Reeves had that insane game. Reeves had a triple-double. Insane. He balled. Yeah. Yes, have to fade. But if AD's out, if he's resting or if LeBron's resting again or some shit, I'm gonna be taking that one off. Okay? He's sitting that one off. Krabs, you ready for the Red Rob special? Yes. Steph Curry, more than 2.5 turnovers. Like I said yesterday, didn't hit. We get the same line on a back-to-back versus the Magic. Curry has cleared that last 7 out of 10 versus them. Javon, thoughts on Steph Curry turning the ball over tonight?
I mean, I can't say I have anything against it. It's just I hate – I mean, we can just go straight to the squares. I hate fading Curry off of playing the Heat and selling everybody yesterday, which I guess selling everybody could just be Trent because I don't know who the hell took Steph Curry overs against the Heat. That was a terrible idea. But – yeah, he was not good yesterday, and that's a product of how the Heat play defense. Not to say the Magic are terribly different, but he's going to get some shots up, dude. That scares me.
Well, that scares me too because I'm fading him on that fucking PP specials combo.
Yeah, I feel like you did that once before and ended in piss. He faded him in one of those combos after a terrible game.
Ended terribly. Yep. People reminded me in chat as soon as we fired this puppy up.
Yeah, and he just sold Trent for, I don't even know the amount, but a lot last night in his goblin.
Well, you know what? I'm bullying him. I don't give a fuck. Bully ball, right, chat? I'm taking it. Combos like that, they don't pay the bills. The more than stop. If you take the less thans on squares like that every time, overall, at the end of the day, you will be up coins. I'm standing on it. Not giving up. Bully ball chat. Two words. Bully. Okay. Steph Curry, Pastrnak, they're not doing shit. I looked at what Pastrnak's been doing. I think he had 4 SAGs the last game. The one before that, he had 1. Maybe he'll take this game off like he did the other game. I don't know. I don't care. All I know is that they're putting these fucking two goats together and they can't keep getting away with it. If they do, Prize Picks might have to shut down.
Yeah, I won't support this one, Krabs. I think it's on
the wow. Okay.
Pasta against the Lightning, too. I mean, that's a big rivalry game, Krabs. Bruins Bolts. I might have a slip. I'm not gonna lie to
slip.
You. I just might.
Turn the Krabs sign on for good luck. It's on, brother. It's on. It's just not as bright with these other lights I got going on. So Lightning boost to win. Yeah, I like the Bruins to win this game, which probably doesn't make any fucking sense as to why I'm taking David Pastrnak, but
Could less than. I mean, if they're losing, I mean, that's a more positive game script for SOGs. But I mean, it's Pasta. He's probably going to rip whatever the game script is.
My prediction: they both end with 4.
I feel like that's reasonable.
Krabs, you will know if this is over very fast. Good. I like that. Javon, rumor has it there's some MLB combos up. for tomorrow, huh? People are
talking. Yeah. Took a little look at those. Texted it to, or I guess you were in that too, you and Trent. You could have 8 Super Goats in 1 4-man slip.
What?
Insane.
What? Absolutely. Dudes, let's take a peep over at those puppies. Total bases and pitcher strikeouts under the PP specials. Shouldn't have to go too far from where you're at right now, brother. There it goes. See ya. 8 goats. 4 square. Crazy. I mean, one of these will hit. 3 of them will probably lose, right? Is there one of these that you have zero interest in fading at all?
I don't know that there's one that I don't want to fade, but I don't want to take either. I haven't looked at these yet too much, other than just screenshotting them and sending them.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, these are fucking crazy, right? I think the one that I want to fade the most is probably the one that's the lowest and looks the freest for people to take the more than. It's the MVP Siegs and Justin Steele. But that's just me. And I don't even know if I want to fade a friend of the program in Justin Steele. So TBD, all right? Just want to put these on notice for you guys. Some nasty combo squares up on the boards for tomorrow's MLB slate. They're already up, primed, ready to go. I believe there's also MLB squares up for the games tomorrow just normally as well. So
yeah,
looking at Josiah Gray as we speak, 5.5 strikeouts. Sure.
There you go. It's probably air. But
yeah. I'll tell you what else is air. If they put it up, it's walk square.
Yeah. That's up there. That's up there.
Yeah. I mean, also opening day nerves, right? His first day, his first time being the opening day starter. That sounds like 3 Josiah Gray walks to me.
Right, Elliot walking stolen base in the first.
If you're looking to bet O squares, they might not come up because this game's probably going to rain out.
No, GG.
Seriously?
Yeah.
GG.
Weren't you about to go too?
Yeah. I might go on Friday if it's rained out too, but we'll see.
Okay. Yeah.
All depends.
Well, that stinks.
Yeah.
I bet.
All right. I mean, there's nothing worse than being out there in 45 degrees when it's fucking pouring down rain.
Yeah.
But it is opening day.
It is opening day.
Shit. All right. Well, let's hope the baseball gods maybe hold off that rain for a little bit. We need opening day. Full force tomorrow. All right. None of this half-ass bullshit, right? None of this one game at 6 a.m. bullshit. We need a full slate of action. Okay? Need it like air. Dubs. Let's finish up this prize picks sharp report. We got to go over these last couple squares. I'm fading Gabe Madsen today. It is what it is. Not happy about it. And no, Hovey, we do not get to fade Patrick Corbin tomorrow. We get to fade him on Saturday. Yeah. Okay. He's going up against Hunter Green on Saturday in Cincy. So that should go well. That game might have 100 runs straight up. We got PP Gurus coming in, giving out a sub. Let's go, PP Gurus. Sure we can. Love that. Z Brown Lee as well coming in, resubbing. 23 months, almost 2 years. Let's go. Love that. All right. W's in chat for the sub banks. All right. Vibes are up. We're hitting a squad ride today. I can fucking tell. I can feel it in my nats. All right, chat. Gabe Madsen had an insane game against Iowa in that last contest. 31 piece, hold the fry. He's at 14.5 points today. Typically, he's around the 13.5 mark. That's what he averages on the season. He's going up against a VCU team that I'll tell you what, they're not going to let him shoot 14 times from behind the arc. Like he was able to do in that last contest where he dropped a 31 piece. He went 7-for-14 from deep. VCU's perimeter defense is like that. They might not win this game with that fat spread, but they're surely going to play defense. And I like that under in that game. So I'm going to fade their best player, Gabe Madsen, after a career high. Fade him. All right. Take the less than 14.5 points against that VCU perimeter defense. I would be shocked if he hits more than 2 threes in this game. I'd be shocked.
Yeah. It's a pretty tough matchup for anybody on Utah, especially a shooter like Madsen. So I don't hate that fade. Could be in on that.
I wanted to take VCU on the spreads, but that number, I already thought it was kind of fat. VCU gets a lot of respect a lot of the times, Javon. None in this spot, and it's moved even fatter. Maybe Utah is just getting mad respect because they're looking great right now. They're looking like a tournament team that they were supposed to be in the beginning of the season. I don't know. What are your thoughts on that spread real quick before we move?
I mean, Utah's like the greatest team of all time at home, so I wasn't too shocked to see it. 14-2 on the season.
But are these games still at home in the quarters?
In the quarters, or
the semis? Sorry, the semis. These are semis.
I thought it was the quarters.
These are semis, folks.
No, I think it's still at home. I think they do the championship now, right? It's only the championship, not the semis.
It looks like this game is at, yeah, it is in Salt Lake. Hence why that spread is a megalodon.
Yeah. So, I mean, they're literally the greatest team of all time at home.
Damn, I thought these were fucking neutral courts. I'm a bozo.
Yeah, dude.
I swear to God, they used to do fucking neutral courts for these.
They used to do an MSG for the semis and on.
Okay. You know Mahoney's on Deaton Thomas's guy?
Of course.
Absolute fucking beast. Absolute beast. Only neutral game today, High Point Seattle, sure. And we already talked about that puppy. It's got to be Seattle. Okay. Javon, thoughts on Gabe Mattson before we move?
Yeah, I'm down with that fade, 100%. VCU's defense is going to make them hell.
I hope so, man. I might have to take them on the spread.
Yeah.
VCU. PP Guru's coming in with 24 bits. Let's go, my man. W's, love to see that. Okay. DJ Fitz says F Seattle. Damn, DJ Fitz. You're not liking him today, huh?
GG Fitz.
Huh. All right, let's move. Let's groove on other squares. We have Goots. I already went over my combo. Javon, I think he's got two as well. Let's go ahead and see what he's got on the Prize Picks board.
Yeah, first one is definitely a little nastier than the second one. Dylan Brooks, 1.5 threes against the Thunder. Thunder, big win off of back-to-back now after beating the Pelicans, and they're steadily becoming a worse and worse catch-and-shoot three-point defense. So, like, guys like Dylan Brooks, Jabari Smith was also up on the board, but it's not anymore because it was just the under. I was probably going to go with that too, but I think the Rockets find a lot of success from the three-point line today, and this is certainly a weird square that I keep my eye on pretty much any time it pops up on the board. I'll take my chances. And the one thing like you kind of want with Dylan Brooks is a matchup where you're going to see a little bit of volume and you're not going to see him taking 1-3 at halftime and you're sitting there wondering when it's going to pop up. But against two games, they had a little back-to-back series against OKC a little month ago. He shot 11 threes in those two games. Went over one time, under the other time. He's also coming off of an 0-for-8 game. That's that last little red bar against Portland. So I love seeing the 1.5 up and starting to get juicier after a guy shoots literal tour dates against one of the worst teams in the league. So they're going to spray today. The Rockets are, and Dylan Brooks is hitting two. And then the other one is a little less nasty. It's probably one of the plays you're going to see, maybe not the threes, but you're going to see this guy's name on Twitter a lot today. And I already have Desmond Bain today. Frogs legend, but
your guy.
Yeah. I mean, this one kind of goes without saying. I'm taking him for the same reason a lot of people are taking him. It's the Lakers off of their Super Bowl. Like, sure, yeah, we want to fade, but it's also like the Lakers are one of maybe the two or three teams that if there's a square on the board that makes a lot of sense and they're going to torch them on the perimeter, I'm going to take it, especially for a high usage guy in that offense when everybody knows how depleted that lineup is. So he's going to do literally whatever he wants from all areas of the court, but especially the three-point line. That's the part of it that I'm kind of inching away from the rest of the people on Twitter taking it because they're just on his points, which I don't know if they're up on Prize Picks anyway. But I think this is one of those games where he spawns in with a couple threes off rip, just like every main perimeter option does against the Lakers. So that's my Page and Curry today, Dylan Brooks and Desmond Bane.
All right, Desmond Bane, a corp friend. That ain't no problem today. You're not getting scared off. You're laying it.
Yeah.
Good. Desmond Bane to bang three or more threes. All right, chats. We're not wavering. John Birdie bang. Yeah, why are you guys so fucking stoked that John Birdie's going to the Yanks?
Yeah, John Birdie's crazy.
Freaking out. They're going nuts in chat for John Birdie getting signed. They're going nuts. Who gives a hoot, chats?
Yeah.
Who gives a hoot? This isn't moving any needles. John Birdie on MVP watch now. This ain't moving any needles, chats. Come on.
Sure. All
right. W Sharp reports. Chat, take a little screenshot of this puppy. All right. We will post this on the Bookit BTL Twitter after the show. But if you want to lock in these puppies early, here they are. All right. Feast your eyes. Do not be scared. We've got plenty of plays, plenty of winners for this Wednesday slate. All right. W's, Javon, it's about that time, brother. We know everyone's excited. We have an hour, 50 minutes-ish left, okay? Plenty of time to craft up the BTL MLB season megalodon for the 2024 season. I know everyone's fucking lit up, all right? We smacked this one last year.
Yeah.
I believe. We smacked something.
This was the BTL one.
We smacked something. Chat, feast your eyes, six piece. hold the fry. All right, we smacked this puppy last year. If you put $100 on it, you won $2,500. If you put $200 on it, you won $5,000. Unbelievable. Okay, we'll let the results speak for themselves here. Unbelievable work. Chat, let's hope we can come close to this. All right, these don't grow on trees, six bases for a season long. But I have a feeling we have a chance. All right, and you can't win if you don't bet. You can't win if you don't play. We're going to give it our best shots to run this puppy back, Javon. Why not us?
Why not?
Why not us? All right. Chat, people forget that. We smacked that six geyser. I think we had another entry as well, a spaces entry.
Yeah. I mean, this one, depending on what we got with Shohei, was actually sick. Would have loved if Luis Garcia played because he was starting to look like Cy Young last couple starts. But Tommy John, unfortunately. But yeah, surgical entry. Daniel Bard, that's seriously in conversations for best square of all time.
Yeah, Circa Hall of Fame called the other day. They said we might need to get you in there for that square.
Yeah.
Straight up. I actually took this entry with Shohei less than 3.14 ERA or 3.13, wherever it got bumped down to. So I lost this entry because I'm a bozo. Still lose sleep over that because Javon's over here throwing a rack to win $10,000 on this puppy. Free. Air.
There.
All right. Chat, we smacked both these puppies last year. People forget. All right. We got a follow coming in. Never Dat 2. Sure. Love that. Thanks for the follow, Beast. What else did we have last year? I think I had my own geyser, man. Yep. This one, it came down to Patrick Corbin. Costing me $12,000. People forget. Get that off my screen. Get that off my screen now. Thank you. W. Goods. Good work. I cannot look at that any longer. I'm going to freak out. Why did I put Corbin in that shit? Why did I put Corbin in that shit? Who let me do that?
Corbin, man.
What kind of friend are you, Javon? Huh?
It's only so much I could do, Krabs.
People forget about that slip.
People do forget.
People forget about
that slip. I don't know. People forget.
Hold that shit back up, dude. So I don't know why you're taking that away. Put that back up. Put that shit back up there. Look at that thing. Look at those other squares. Daniel Barrett. Bless his heart. We'll leave it at that. I could go on for hours. I won't. Okay, we'll let him be. Aaron Judge, free. Anyone who took Aaron Judge more than home runs last year, you're a bozo. You're a shit better. I'm better than you. Patrick Corbin, not going to talk about it. Trey Turner, free. Cal Quantrill, free. Miguel Cabrera, bless his heart, Hall of Famer. He wasn't hitting six nukes. Are you guys smoking crack? Have you seen Miguel Cabrera swing a bat the last 5 years? Come on. Not going to lie, that one got a little bit sweaty. That one got a little bit sweaty. Not going to lie to you. I think he ended up with four or some shit. Oh, yeah, I know, Goots. Thanks. Yep, he had a nine-piece. That was against the Astros, I believe. Scroll to the left there. I remember that one clear as day. Was that against the Astros? Oh, Seattle. I forgot he had two. Nice. Nice. Goodness gracious, man. Did he have another nine-piece?
I feel like he had...
I'm making that up. I thought he had one more.
Eight.
Eight-piece? Was that against the... Okay, that was against
the Pirates one.
I might be making shit up. Then what was, either way.
What was the Mariners one at the end of the season?
It was Mariners. I could have sworn he had eight or nine against the Astros, but I could be making that up.
I feel like he had like a crazy start against the Astros, then had nothing for like the end of his like couple innings in the outings.
Yeah, B. Joe, and if I was 8 feet tall, I could dunk.
Yeah, I mean, that's literally part of the cap.
Man.
Especially for a guy like Judge.
All right, let's move. Let's groove. Enough of that fucking entry, but wanted to go through that puppy real quick. W is part of betting. Yep, is what it is. Is what it is. Okay. Those entries are in the past, Javon. Look, they were unbelievable. All right, people are still talking about them. I'm going to tell my grandkids about those things. But those are in the past. All right, we have to move on. We have entries to craft up for this season, and we don't have much time. Javon, are there any squares that you are absolutely obsessed with for this upcoming season that you feel like have to be in the BTL season long mag?
Well, the one that is, it's not my main entry, which I guess this is kind of what that's for, that I really, really like, is that Anthony Volpe multi-home run game square.
You know I'm in.
Yeah, no, you're in for that. Yeah, he hasn't done it, obviously, in his rookie season he didn't do it, but... I think as much as we hate the Yankees, I think he's going to have a really good season, especially if he ends up making his way up in that lineup. I think we're going to see a little bit of a power surge from him. He's been working on a swing path really the entire season or off season. He looks a lot more comfortable in the spring. And the most important part is he's hitting the ball to all fields. So we all know if you're playing in Yankee Stadium, you don't exactly need the ball to be hit 450 if you're sending it the opposite way as a righty to get it out. So like, I think we're going to see him be a little streaky in the season, which is why I don't love like just taking the home runs or the hits. But I think we're going to see a two home run game for Volpe.
Sign me up. Goots, put that shit in there, brother. Anthony Volpe, more than a half multi home run game. I'm in. Sign me up. Anthony Volpe, he will be the leadoff hitter for this team once DJ LeMahieu loses his job. Bless his heart. The machine.
He's hurt now, so he might honestly be.
He might be right off
very,
the rip.
Very soon. Yeah, I don't know what they're going to do with that lineup.
Might be right off the rip. Yep. All right, we'll see. Either way, Volpe's smashing two in one game. I'm in. All right. Javon, what else we need? You want me to throw one out there?
Sure.
Jack Flaherty?
Ooh.
Have you come officially to Jack Flaherty yet?
I have, just because, I mean, this is about for him to stay healthy. That's all it is. Like, if he's even relatively healthy, this is not even going to be close. Not even going to be close. He's going to soar over this.
Have we seen any movement on this?
I don't think so.
Probably don't have eyes on that. It's okay.
Well, it's also because he was like the bottom of the strikeout board with all the lower totals. It's also what came out like last. It's like they were on the board for easily the shortest.
Chat, we will talk about Abrams after this. Don't worry, okay? We will talk about Abrams after this. For now, we have to talk about Flaherty. Let me give you guys my little pitch, all right? I was watching Jack Flaherty pitch the other day, one of his last outings of the spring. And by the way, he's looked great this entire spring, knock on woods. All right. Big season coming up for Jack Flaherty. Big year. A lot of expectations, a lot of pressure. If he doesn't have a healthy season and a solid year, it's probably GG's for Jack Flaherty, right? He's running out of time to prove himself in this league. The guy just can't stay healthy, plain and simple. If he pitches 120 innings this year, he hits this number. It's that easy. Like Javon said, we are literally betting on this guy to stay healthy. It's tough. I personally want to do it. I want to buy low. I want to take a risk. I want to take a stab at Jack Flaherty because if he does stay healthy, this will be the freest square on earth. Straight up.
Yeah.
The freest square on earth. Okay. I'm buying into Jack Flaherty. All right. And I've heard a lot of other aspects of this bet as well that I've liked. Their new catcher, very good at framing. That's a big upgrade. I heard the pitching coach talking about that during their game and during his outing. His velocity's up. His accuracy has been great so far in the spring. His strikeout numbers have been significantly higher this year on Detroit's going into the fucking season. He looks unbelievable. He looks great. He's filling up the zone. He's healthy. He's got high velo. He's got a good catcher. I'm in on Jack Flaherty this season. I think this kid balls, and if he throws 120 innings, this is going to be the easiest square on earth.
Yeah, it will be, 100%. So, the truth is, like, looking at the number, obviously, it's not a bet on him to stay healthy for the entirety of the season. We can at least say that's the reason why this number is so low in the first place, because he hasn't been able to do it. So
yeah, he's going to miss some games.
He's going to miss some games. Yeah, right? It's Jack Flaherty. He's not going to stay completely healthy, but with this number, we have a good bit of flexibility, which is fine.
Are you in on Jack Flaherty?
Yeah, and I don't think he has a new, like, repertoire necessarily, but he's been working. I mean, the velocity is significantly up, so we'll see how long that lasts. It's looked great in spring. Fastballs look great. He's not walking nearly as many guys. The walk rate is down quite a bit in the spring. We'll see how that lasts too, but I'm excited to watch Flaherty.
Actually, hold on, we'll get to that in a sec. Javon, are you in on Jack Flaherty to go in the BTL season long neck?
I'm in on that.
All right. Goots, do your job. Put him in that puppy.
Could be the difference.
Any day now. Good.
He's got it on the screen.
He's in there.
Yeah.
He's in there? All right, good.
Yeah.
Kyle Gibson, less than half 10-plus K games. We talked about this on the spaces last night. You know, Kyle Gibson, I saw a bunch of highlights of him striking out 100 people the other day. Has he been nails in the spring? Has he been changing something up? I've been seeing these pitching ninja videos of Kyle Gibson looking like he's fucking Aroldis Chapman right now.
Yeah,
is it just me? Bad. Am I the only one getting these fucking videos on my algorithm? What's going on here?
Yeah, I mean, he's been like really good. He's been really good, dude.
Fuck. This square is literally Patrick Corbin. 10 plus strikeout games from last year.
This is not Patrick Corbin. Because like
Gibson, 7 Ks in 5 yesterday.
Gibson's actually done it. Yeah, I saw you actually had 9.
He had 9 Ks.
He had 9. And he had, like last year, he had 2 games with 11 strikeouts. So it's not like Corbin where like nobody's ever done it. It's like I'm pretty scared to fade Kyle Gibson.
I mean, that's nasty right there.
That is filthy.
Wow.
That's a force. All right. I've heard enough, chat. I've heard enough. That's a force.
This too. Like, especially with Sonny Gray injured to start the season, like, they're going to be innings eaters. It's like they're going to keep him in for a while.
Is it weird that that's the only square up for him, though?
Yeah, like, I think it's one of the weirdest squares ever, Gates. I think it's weird. But maybe that's just me.
He's an O's legend, so I wouldn't mind it.
I mean, I know that they're not playing the division as much this year, but that's probably the division that I most do not want to fade any strikeouts against. Like, the Reds strike out a ton. The Pirates strike out a ton. You see what he just did to the Cubs, and they strike out a ton. That's just like, that's scary. I mean, the Brewers didn't even mention them because I don't know what they're going to be this season, but they also strike out a ton.
A lot of good recommendations in chats. All right, as we get a B Clem resub, love to see that. WB Clem, W Vibes. Okay.
Well, you know what's looking at me funny from what we heard yesterday? Because I guess last season, I'm pretty sure Jordan under from Pete was in our BTL Meg, right? That Matt Olson under from mid-major Matt is ringing in my ears.
I mean, that shit's hitting.
That shit is hitting. That's the gross one that we might have to put in there after a career year. He's one of the guys where, like, you don't want to take spring training like too much, put it too much in the forefront of your head, but what we've seen from him like so far this year is a little alarming, and it's definitely selling really high on a guy who just had an insane season too, and he's not a guy who misses many games or hasn't in like the last couple of years.
Right.
That might be it right there, Krabs.
Now, I am more than down to take this in something. Do I want to take this in the BTL Meg when it's mid-major Matt Square? That's when I'm a little bit sketched.
But we don't have like a spaces entry this year. It's like, I feel like it's just like tip your cap, pay homage to Matt, because that was a great play, just like Jordan with Pete.
Chad, what do you guys think? If we take other people's squares that they pitched in that spaces yesterday and shout them out, do you guys want that, or do you want it to just be squares from our brains? What do you guys want? We have heard a couple of good ones, like Fat Girls Inks, Say S. Zinkovich. That
was also
pretty solid as well. Yeah, you guys don't give a hoot, do you?
Yeah, we just need a green slip. That's what we need.
Green is green. Whatever's green. Okay. All right. I mean, it's hitting.
Yeah. I mean, the Olsen square and the Saya square were both fantastic. And yeah, the Olsen number is low. I don't know how much higher you can put them necessarily, but I mean, after a record-setting season, I think there will be plenty of value on fading some Braves, not named Michael Harris.
All right, let's put him in there. Less than 42 and a half home runs.
Yeah.
After a 53-piece, I believe, last year. I
think 53, 54, somewhere.
Yeah, something like that.
53.
Sure. I'm on Saya, dude is raking.
I know.
Yeah, I really like that Saya pitch from Fat Girls.
Yeah.
Goods. Oh, he's gone.
Say it again.
I didn't know if you had something to say. You popped up here.
No, 54 home runs.
Okay, 54. Good.
Yep.
Okay. Season-long baseball picks, who cares? I'm not letting my money sit in the book account for 5 months. All right, well, you should probably get watched somewhere else, brother.
Why are you
How come here, I can't brother? See MLB season-long on my prize picks? I don't know, Caesar. Hit the old refresh button, will you, brother? Hit the old refresh. Max Freed's. Now, I wouldn't mind backing Max Fried. The deal. His less than ERA, potentially.
Do you want to double up on Braves, though?
Even though
they're not for the same thing.
Not necessarily. I'm okay with keeping him out. Just talking through the chat. What do we have so far right now? We got 3 in that puppy, huh?
Yeah, we do have 3.
Volpe, Flaherty, Olsen.
I'm surprised I haven't heard that out of your mouth yet.
Well, we could talk about it. We could talk about some Nats.
Lane Thomas.
A couple of Nat squares that are hitting. You know, there's Lane Thomas under home runs, which I don't really see why we don't just put that in there right now. there is CJ Abrams steals. There's CJ Abrams more than half a multi-home run game. There's Mackenzie Gore strikeouts. There's Mackenzie Gore more than, you know, 10 plus strikeout games. There's a lot. Are you leaning towards any of these guys, runs?
I mean, twist my arm on a lot of them. I don't love Mackenzie Gore, I guess, because, I mean, you've talked about it. Strikeout angle's kind of tough. Not a strikeout pitcher, necessarily. And they're going to need some serious innings out of him. So we'll see how his approach is. But I wouldn't be against backing CJ Abrams or fading Lane Thomas at all.
Is Corbin 10Ks on the board by chance? No, Dig Dad is not. Appreciate the question there, brother. Appreciate that. As a Nats fan, I'm worried about Abrams' regression. Yeah, so am I, Joel. So am I. I don't see how he doesn't get 40 steals there, brother. I know everybody loves him this year. I'm with you. My gut's telling me we put in Lane fade and we go about our day. That's a green square.
Okay. Let's do it.
Oh, man. What could go wrong, right?
Yep.
Just had a kid, too, so he's got dad strength.
Sure. Fading dad strength, man. Fading dad strength.
We're fading dad strength.
Dude, the dad strength. That might make me a little hesitant.
I mean, it's turning green. He's not hitting 20 home runs. Bless his heart.
Okay. Amen.
He's not hitting 20 Ks.
Amen.
I hope I'm wrong. But this looks exactly like the Manessa square that I got asked to put up last year that was way too high, and he had 5 home runs. So, lefty merchant. I know, chat. I know. And Lane just hit his 3rd home run on Father's Day. I bet, Alan. I'll probably be there with my pops as well. Watching Lane Thomas just hit 4 home runs in the same game. 4 pitches. Unbelievable. What if he gets traded? I mean, we have not been able to find a fucking trade partner for Lane Thomas the last 2 seasons. He's not getting traded.
Yeah, I mean, if they're going to trade him, and I feel like it was going to be last season. So if they didn't, I feel like they're pretty set on holding on to him.
Yep. Krabs, we need Jelloff over homers.
Jelloff Bonds.
I know we were looking at that Jelloff Bonds more than 19 and a half home runs. Is there any legitimacy to that one?
I mean, there is. It's just like it's a tough one because he's such a boomer bust guy. A lot of swing and miss, and it seems to have kind of gotten worse throughout like the end of last year and early in the spring, I guess you could say too. So like, I like it. I would love to root for Jelloff. It's just, he's probably going to go in a cold stretch this season, which is not great.
Love this, though. Absolutely love this. Flaherty, yeah. A little bit higher on the books.
Whoa.
Good. Dude, what?
Is that a fact?
Dude, what is going on with these guys, man?
What the fuck?
Dude, what?
He's literally giving up.
Like air.
This is giving up. He's giving up.
Literally giving up.
There's no way this is real, is it? Who's Simon Charles?
That's got to be Cap.
Nah, this guy's fake, bro. This has got to be Cap.
Email anatomy. What the fuck? Yeah.
Cap.
Get that out of here. God, they almost got us, huh, Gitz?
Gotta check the bio first, I guess.
Fake bang.
Always gotta check out those guys who were tweeting. That is wild. Literally an NFL fake beat reporter. Good. Anyways, back to business here. Zach Jelloff Bonds.
He wants a UVA Krabs. I don't know if that matters to you.
All right, I'm out. I'm out.
Instantly out.
You're putting Zach Allen in yours, right?
Yeah, Zach Allen's in mine.
Okay.
I'll tell you, I'm still on the fence about one square, or I guess one spot for two guys. And I'll tell you which ones they are. It's two home run squares. It's Tristan Casas and Carlos Correa. Those are the two that have been going back and forth for the final spot in the go-well. You have any thoughts on either of those guys?
I mean, is Carlos Correa going to be able to stay healthy enough?
You would hope so. But, I mean, yeah, I think he's going to have a pretty massive bounce back year.
I mean, I like both those squares. I probably like the Casas one a little bit better, but the one thing that worries me about him is who the hell's going to be hitting behind him if they don't make moves.
I mean, the lineup is good. It's not like it's bad. He's going to be hitting around Devers and Yoshida. It's not like they can pitch around him.
Yeah. I think I like Casas better.
I do too. And that's probably going to end up in mine. But that Correa is staring me in the face, Krabs.
Casas might hit 40 because Trent took Devers. I bet. What about some Marlins players to fade? Yeah. I wouldn't mind fading Lizardos on his ERA.
Lizardos. Larry Bird knows what's up.
Yeah, that Larry Bird might be tapped.
Adley's going off. Sure. Nats tomorrow. Please no, Devin. Please no. Best bet of the season, best future for the MLB this year, Nats win total under. It is what it is.
People do forget within the span of 10 seconds, Krabs went from Nats worst team in the league to might sneak into the playoffs.
And that's baseball, folks. And that's baseball. Wouldn't have it any other way. Far from MLB sharp. How does who hits behind him affect his home run chances? Well, Stoney, I mean, if there's nobody hitting behind him, definitely worried about people pitching around these guys, right? So if you have a Mushik guy hitting behind someone and he's towards, you know, the middle of the lineup, hitting fifth or sixth, there's nobody hitting seventh or eighth that's really good. You know, why pitch to that guy? Why throw him any strikes? Why throw him any meat? But you could just pitch around him and get to the next batter. That's why. You know, taking some of these guys to be successful when nobody's hitting behind them scares me a little bit. Now, we could bring up the Pete Alonso angle that I cannot get over, and I keep bringing it up every day.
I figured that was going to be in your personal go well.
Yeah, probably. I haven't really locked anything in there yet, though. I wanted to do this.
I mean,
one
we
first.
Could do. I feel like it would be smart, too. I mean, we could double down on our favorite squares. So I would have no problem doing that. Put double like dip. One, our favorite square from our own go well into this one.
That works perfect. We got four in there, so two more.
Was this a six-piece last year?
It was a six-piece.
Yes.
I mean, I think you're right in there with Alonso. I love that square.
I do, but I'm also a little bit thrown off now because I don't know if I want to go RBIs or home runs now after what we talked about in the spaces.
I mean, I think RBIs, it's my opinion. I think it's a solid look. I think that lineup is going to score runs.
Mets are moose. I know, Remy Lowe.
They're really not, though. It's the thing. Their pitching is kind of moose, and it gets –
they're going to be in a lot of high-scoring games.
Yeah, I mean, that lineup is good. That lineup is good. Nimmo Lindor hitting above Alonso. Jack McNeil's probably going to hit behind Alonso. Yeah, but yeah. I mean, Nimmo, Lindor, Francisco Alvarez is probably going to be up there for some games. They switch up the lineup. Like, it's not a bad lineup. Like, it's actually pretty talented, especially when you compare it to, like, I mean, it's years better than the other two cellar-dweller teams in the NL East. Not your playing division as much, but, like, I think the lineup is just fine. It's a solid lineup.
You want to go RBIs?
I'm down for that.
Got to fade Soler bombs and San Fran. I'm good, Nicholas. I'm good on that one, brother. All right. Pete Alonso, more than 108.5 RBIs.
Could be the move, Krabs.
Let's put that in there for now. Dilly Daggers, sub bang coming in hot 8 months. Love to see that. We made it to opening day. Yes, sir. Dilly Daggers, good seeing you out there in Vegas as well.
Yeah. There you go.
All right.
Sub bang rumors.
Well, who are we rooting for, chat? Let's go, Royals. Sure.
Royals.
We're all a little bit of Royals fans in this BTL chat.
Oh, 100%.
Just a little bit.
100%.
You know? W Aloha. Love to see that. We got subs galore. Feel like we have no pitchers we are married to this year. Yeah, I mean, the Zach Gallen one's a pretty good look. I really like the Jack Flaherty angle. You know, Justin Steele, less than strikeouts, was an interesting one from Pete last night. I don't know if I want to fade our guy, friend of the program, but I'll tell you what. Justin Steele's probably not getting 170 strikeouts. Bless his heart. Tariq Skubal, right? We saw Phils come in to the spaces yesterday and pitch that. Tariq Skubal, more than 169.5 strikeouts. That's one that everybody likes, but I'm in on. Like that play. Chiote, honorable glaze. Garcia might be a whale. Sure.
Michael Garcia. Hmm. Goat.
I was at the Fontainebleau, but I never saw y'all. Really, Dave Martinez? Shit, dude. Well, that place is absolutely electric, and I hope we get invited back because it was awesome.
Yeah.
We had a time. We had an absolute time. What is the deadline to lock these in? I believe it is whenever the, you know, first game of the team season starts up. So, you know, for the Nats, it's 4:10 tomorrow Eastern. For, you know, the Rangers, it's 7:35 Eastern against the Cubbies. So just make sure you lock these puppies in before the team's games start. All right.
What about Vladdy?
Ooh, I forgot about Vladdy.
Can't forget about Vladdy.
Because, I mean, I really like Vladdy, and I will have Bobby Witt in my goat whale. So I didn't want to take two squares that were also in Trent's goat whale and double up there. So I would not be mad at putting Vladdy in this entry.
What would you take on Vladdy?
I mean, I like the hits. I like the RBIs, both of them. I'm not really married to one of them because he was the most unlucky hitter by a pretty wide margin in the MLB last year. Also hooked under for Pete's entire go wheel to hit on that same hits line, I'm pretty sure. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, another lineup that I think is going to score runs too. It's like they have a couple options. Everybody's like always hyping up the Blue Jays every year. Feels like it's gotten significantly quieter this year because Vladdy was shit last year. It was a big letdown. Like that whole lineup was super inconsistent. Springer was ass for a long stretch before he got hot for a brief time. Varsho is going to be in there having a solid season. Davis Bonds is going to be in there. Who knows where he's going to be at? Like, I don't want to have two RBI squares in there for throwing Pete, but I like the hits.
Yeah, what's he at right now on the board? He's at 165.5.
Yes, and this MLB The Show cover curse is not a thing. Literally not a thing. I don't know why who started that or whatever. St. Madden. Like Shohei was on it 2 years ago.
Well, we saw Vladdy have 188 and 175 hits in 2021 and 2022. Last year, he took a little bit of a step back, had a couple less games played, handful. And maybe that cost him, I don't know. But he ended up with 159 hits. Went under for everybody, right? We heard Pete, everybody bitching. Now they put him up even higher after that season. Huh. Maybe we just take Vladdy hits and we just go about our debt.
Yeah.
Are we worried about conditioning?
No. Not really.
Okay.
Because they also have a guy now to take him off his feet a little bit. It's like they're going to be, I can only assume, like, I don't know how often it's going to be happening, but he's not going to have to play the field as much this season, you would think. Because they got guys to kind of slot in there now. Like Justin Turner. Justin Turner will probably play first base a couple of games. And they'll give Vladdy a couple extra DH games.
Good. Good. Surprise you guys aren't on Soto under home runs. Yeah. Dead Larry Bird, even I don't want to sign up for that shit. You know who will be in my go well, though. It's not Soto. But it will be a less than home runs. And it will hit.
Yeah.
Judge. Talk about Judge. He's going in that shit.
Is he?
Yep.
That's unreal, dude.
Has to be done.
That's unreal.
Has to be done. I can't get behind Soto. I think Soto goes nuclear this season. I can get behind Aaron Judge. Who got bumped down 3 home runs for no fucking reason.
Well, it's for a reason. He's hurt.
He's healthy as an ox from the Yankees fans right now. Healthy as an ox.
Spring beat up.
He's ready to roll.
Spring beat up is crazy.
Gotta regret that one. You guys are acting like he wasn't the freest square on earth last year. I don't get it.
Yeah, it was the same thing everybody said last year.
There it back, goes.
Back to back. Yeah. Back to back is crazy, Krabs.
Yeah. I mean, it is what it is, but if a square like that hits, I feel like I have to run it back.
Fair.
We'll see. Chad, I'm dropping that puppy later today. All right. What do we have so far? Are we putting in that Vladdy hits? I'm more than down.
I think we put Vladdy hits in there. 100%.
This is a six piece.
Let's take a peep at it. Nothing's finalized here. We got Volpe, more than half a multi-home run game. Jack Flaherty, by and low, more than 128.5 strikeouts. Excuse me. We got Matt Olson, less than 42.5 home runs. Sure. Lane Thomas, fading the dad strength. That should go well. Fading a Nat, that should go well. Less than 22.5 home runs.
Should definitely go
We got
well.
Pete Alonso, more than 108 season RBIs. And we've got Vladdy, bounce back here, more than 165 hits. Chat, what are we thinking about this puppy? Javon, Goots, what are your guys' thoughts? All ears.
As much as I agree with the Lane take, it's giving me bad vibes.
I was just going to say that. It's giving me bad vibes.
Bad vibes.
Yes, these will all be posted on Twitter, my man. You want to take out Lane, huh?
Yeah.
You want to put in your favorite square, Zach Gallen?
I mean, that's up to you. Or we can, I mean, there's still squares out there that I think are pretty solid. We do still have a guy who's now going to be, Davis to take out Lane, now gonna be in a playing opening day, which I didn't expect. Nolan Bonds and Coors.
He's back, huh?
Ow.
He's
back.
So, I mean, we have Gallen, we have Abrams, if you want to switch Nats. We have Nolan Bonds. We still have options.
How many pitchers we got right now? One?
Why don't I see him?
Yeah, we just have one, right?
Who are you looking for, Gates?
Nolan.
Did he get taken off board again?
Damn.
No. They put him back up after he got announced that he was playing.
He's out.
Now he's gone again. There.
He gone.
GG, dude, GG.
He gone. Well, Abrams steals. No Nats because steam crabs of everything, but the Nats don't hit. We'll be an hour long. Good point, Joel. Joel's getting out. He's getting out ahead of it. I don't blame that.
Gunner.
Arenado, we were talking about the other night. Sure.
We're talking about Arenado.
Gunner Henderson.
Yeah, Goots, where's your fucking meat on tape, square?
Yeah, where's your nugs, Goots?
My meat on tape is already done. It was House on Kim.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right.
It's already going.
Fuck.
You are right.
Abrams is 36.5 SBs. That's not good. On the blue book.
Yeah, stolen base lines aren't really sharp wherever you go.
What about Torque?
Ooh, Torque. CH Nukes. He's not on board, is he, Fat Girls? Strand?
No, he's not, I don't think.
Yeah, I was gonna say there's no way he's on the board. Or else that would have been my go well. Rays, yeah, Yankees trade, bang. Who the fuck are they trading?
Ben Revident.
What the fuck? I mean, it's better than what the Rays have. Rene Pinto. He's probably going to be starting damn near opening day now.
Involved in that birdie
opening
trade.
Series. Oh, Rays slotted in the birdie trade. Sure.
Sure.
Damn.
Well, it's better than having Rene Pinto. Only a catcher on the roster.
Put some respect on Pinto Beans, to Jen saying. He seems pretty happy.
He's ass, dude. Pinto's ass, respectfully.
Damn.
As much as I want him to be good, he's ass.
Ultimate MLB The Show King Noodle Bat. Huh. Krabs, O'Neal Cruz, please. We can't do that. We can't do O'Neal Cruz.
No Cruz missiles?
Can't do O'Neal Cruz. No. Can't do O'Neal Cruz. I think I'm also out on
Torque.
We could put Saya in there from Fat Girls.
Could be a sign that when we went to Chicago, I kind of just bought a Saya jersey just because it was there. And they had it like for $50 or some shit, and we're going to the game.
I remember that.
Yeah.
I bought the hot dog t-shirt. You bought the, you know, discounted jersey.
Yeah.
Was that sure. A Vladdy bump I saw?
Bump? Where?
You got him at 165? Oh.
Now, wait a damn minute.
I have him at 164.
Wow. Good. Good.
Bump
okay. Unbelievable. Is Wyatt Langford up? No, I wish. So we could fade him. That'd be cool, though. Gosh, man. Maybe it is Saya.
Could just be Saya. I love that sell job from Fat Girls. And he's been... That's like the one guy on the Cubs I am petrified of.
Fat Girl, stand up, bro. You can sit there silently and chat. What's going on?
No, he's been,
I know
he's
you're
been
in here lurking, bro.
He's been talking.
I know he's in here lurking. Saya is underrated. Yes, I know. Yeah. He's also the hottest hitter right now in baseball.
You know what we can put in there?
Who?
Mahomes less than passing yards.
Dude. Start rolling it over, putting one square from another season.
Yeah, electric.
We could just say cut the shit and put Abram stolen bases in there.
It's not a bad shot either. I'm not going to argue that.
My gut tells me Saya. My heart tells me Abrams. My brain tells me Gallon.
Ooh, that was a sneaky third brain play.
A lot of thoughts going on right now.
Why is Gallon not already in this?
Well, because we're trying to craft a BTL Geiserman, and we didn't know if we wanted to pull some from our, you know, solo units. But I'm getting to the point where I kind of want to see green. Last year, we smacked our BTL six piece. People forget. Maybe we keep it simple and we do put, you know, our favorite squares in there. I got my Pete square in there. You've got your Zach Gallon ERA square in there. And we go about our day.
Yeah,
but that's also less fun.
It is also kind of less fun. I feel like the fun of it is kind of expanding our investments.
Want to run a duck race?
I can't sleep at night knowing a duck race decided this.
Everyone chat's gonna start saying quack now. Watch, excuse me, quack. Oh, okay. Quack. There we go.
There
they come. Okay.
I don't know. Ask the chat, man. What do we want to do? Gallon's green. But I feel like we can also craft multiple green squares, regardless of where we go.
I don't know, man. They just keep saying quack. Vlad hits removed. There's no fucking way.
No, it's still right there.
Dude, what are we doing?
Bro, fake banging, bro. I bet.
What are we doing? All right.
Can we ban on Twitter?
All right. Should we let them? Should we run a poll? Or should we just pick?
They want to run a poll. They probably want a poll.
All right, let's get chat.
So what are the options? So the options are Gallon, Abrams, and what?
Yeah, let's go Saya, more than 21 and a half home runs. Let's go Abrams, steals. And let's go Gallon ERA.
Well, do we also, what do we want to do? Do we want to keep Pete in there too? Because that's also going to be in yours for leaving out mine. So I guess you should.
Yeah, I open, think we see how this plays option. Out. I think we see how this poll plays out. And if your Gallon square gets put in there, we definitely leave.
If Gallon goes in, we'll leave in Pete. But if not, we'll go with the other two.
Okay. All right.
I'm going to run it for sure. 2 minutes.
2 minute poll chat. You guys are involved. All right. You guys help us pick this BTL season long Megalodon. All right. I'm throwing $1,000 on this puppy. Lock the fuck in.
Make sure I have it right. Seiya, home runs, Abram steals, Gallon ERA, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Perfect. We'll let chat decide what they like the best. Chad, pick the winner. Pick the winner. All right. Don't pick the one you want to sweat out the most. Don't pick the biggest name. Don't pick the guy you want to watch on Thursday, right? On opening day tomorrow. Pick the winner, will you?
Abrams.
I'm putting a rack-a-roon on this puppy. I believe. All right. We've done our jobs. We've done our work. We have plenty of squares, plenty of options. Oh, now yeah. We get you guys involved.
Gallon's more, my bad.
Gallon people, is people more than ERA.
The people know that. We're good.
Gallon is more than ERA. Wow, Abrams steals. People Abrams. Love that. People
so
love
it,
that.
So shit. If it holds, we'll go Abrams steals and Seiya.
Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. Jack, get those deads in. Hurry up. Go, 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 go. We're going to do the squad ride here in a moment. But for now, we got to get the fucking MLB, BTL, season-long Megalodon crafted.
Final Are we taking out Pete?
If this poll stands, yeah.
Okay.
If this poll stands, yeah. Which I am more than fine with, and we probably should keep it separate.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Probably shouldn't overlap. It's kind of like cheating. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't know if I bought that. It's just fun.
Might be worse. Might be worse. No fun around here, Javon. Only winners. No fun allowed.
Wander home runs.
The squad rides have been going, and we should not be allowed to have any fun.
Yeah, we got to pick up the fun.
Straight up.
Hopefully get one today before baseball.
Chad, if this squad ride doesn't hit tonight, I'll give away $100 on BTL tomorrow. All right? We're cold. Only one way to change the vibes. All right. If the squad ride doesn't hit tonight, I will give away $100 in chat on BTL tomorrow. Remind my ass. Remind my ass in chat. All right. Did someone say Matt Wallner? Ooh.
He's on my fantasy team, so y'all be better saying Wallner every day.
Dude, imagine we were able to put him in the go whale. He used to have crabs come on and say his name every day.
Yeah.
I mean, that would have played.
That would have been a cheat code.
Yeah. When are the personals dropping? Mine's dropping later today.
Jermaine. Yeah, mine too.
Good.
As soon as I get graphic.
Good. Love that. Riley Kugel to the transfer portal. Yeah, guys, let's just keep the portal out of the talk today because all it does is piss me off because everyone's leaving. Man. All right. CJ Abrams steals. Not mad about it one bit. You know, I'm more than down to sweat this out the entire season. Are you kidding me, guys? Right up the street. Come on. That's elite. And we will take out Pete, and we will put in Seiya from Fat Girls, and we'll give Fat Girls and Mid-Major Matt their flowers when we post this puppy because those two squares are from them.
Yes.
All right? So, Goots, if we can show the six-piece, if possible.
Yep.
I'm happy to fill in the gaps if needed. But we should be solidified here, folks. And I'm going to lock this puppy in now.
Yeah, I'm about to, too.
Can we get the more thans and the less thans all together? Is that possible? Am I asking for the world?
Let me do
it. Like that. You can do that.
Let me do it.
All right.
Let me make crabs.
Gotta look pretty. We're gonna be looking at this thing all year, huh?
Real pretty.
Gotta be pretty. Come on, chats. People forget we literally smacked the six piece last year doing the same shit.
It's only one lesson, so.
Okay. Yeah, just throw it on the end, I guess. Yep. Link, yes, I will put the link in here right now, but let me lock in this puppy. All right, we got Volpe. Excuse me. Definitely have some sort of disease from Las Vegas. I really can't smell that well. We're not gonna talk about it.
Captain
Volpe,
Cap.
Captain Cap. Barely smell. Crazy.
Not gonna ask any questions. Volpe Flaherty. We've got Vlad. Volpe, Flaherty, Vladdy. I'm liking the sounds of these. Vladdy E's. Who else we got?
CJ.
CJ? Come on, CJ, you motherfucker. Get those legs loose. Get those legs loose. Suzuki. And then who is the less than puppy?
Olsen.
Yeah, Matt Olsen.
Yeah, I love that square. It's just nasty. I'll be honest, when Matt was pitching that on the spaces yesterday, I didn't hear a word that came out of his mouth. It didn't matter. Because all that mattered was that he's taken Matt Olson after having a career season. The guy's been the healthiest, luckiest guy in baseball. Not luckiest, but healthiest guy in baseball the last couple seasons. He's been mashing. Well, why is that number a little low? In that lineup too, in that ballpark too, baseball's like the fly. He's getting 40 on the nose, and that's it. I'm liking it.
Yeah,
there's not an O in
here. I wish Matt was in here so we could gas him up, but we will on Twitter.
Yeah,
we will on Twitter. All right, chat. Six piece. Hold the fry. I'm going to drop the link in here right now, and then we're going to do the squad rides. Okay. Volpe, more than half multi-home run games. Jack Flaherty, more than 128 and a half strikeouts. Vladdy, more than 165 and a half hits. CJ Abrams, more than 38 and a half stolen bases. Seiya Suzuki, more than 21 and a half home runs. And Matt Olson, less than 42 and a half home runs. Book that shit. I'm putting a rack of room. Wow, I got a free six piece from Taylor Trentz, I think.
I know. I was looking at that. I feel like I shouldn't use that on this.
Gentlemen, it's making me use this.
It's time for the MLB Goat Whip.
Let's go. Come on, Sharklar. Sure we can. Love that, bro. I mean, it's making me place it with this, Jermon. I don't really know what else to do, bro.
I know. I might make another six band just to bullshit. Use that as my free entry.
To win 5K? So what's the risk on that?
How much did you put on Trent's entry?
250, I believe.
That's it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Huh. Well, I'm still going to place it for a rack. I don't give a shit. The other one will just be a bonus. All right. Rackaroon to win 25 racks. Holy shit. Holy shit. That's crazy. $1,000 to win 25K. We're locked.
Be so locked.
We're locked. All right. I'm going to send you guys this link right now. We're going to get the squad ride moving and grooving. Goods, run that shit. W's link is right here, spawning in chats. There it goes. Lock it in. Go, go, go. Hurry up. Prize Picks wouldn't let me up my shit, so I can only win 10K. Hit them up on their supports and ask for a higher limit if you want. All right? Chats, it's about that time. We have been moose shit with the squad rides of late. Okay? Plain and simple. Moose shit. Haven't hit one in the week. Have to lock in today, Javon. What are we loving on this Wednesday slate?
You know, I cannot get that Bulls pick from you out of head. Really can't.
I am more than down. Take the Bulls plus 2.5, making sure there's no bullshit line movements or injuries since we've been on here. Looks pretty good to me.
Looks pretty solid. I mean, Seattle too. Moving to favorite. It's kind of hard to ignore.
I'm really liking Seattle as well. That's a 5 p.m. start, though. It starts in 3 hours, Javon.
Ooh. 5 p.m. Eastern. It's kind of early. It's kind of early.
It's an early start, folks.
That can be unofficial. Unofficial.
Okay. Unofficial early sweats.
Yeah, early sweat, early squad ride. I mean, we both like Clippers.
6.5.
Yeah, they're moving, they're grooving. That game's probably, I mean, if it's close, they're probably going to lose. It's like I have no idea or no problem laying the points because I think they're going to win by a lot.
They either cover by a million or they get blown out and lose outright?
Yeah, I'm not worried about anything happening in between.
All right, so we'll do Seattle ML. We'll do the Bulls plus 2.5. We will do Clippers minus 6.5. Is that what they're up to now?
Yeah, I see some 6.5s. Dude, what about – I mean, I feel good about the Senators. I know people are probably not going to vote for that and go to the ice, but we have two-game slates. And what have we learned from very short two-game, three-game slates? You take the sketchy dogs. Take the sketchy dog.
One of those dogs is barking.
Yeah, I mean, one of the dogs is the Bruins, and that's a chalky – I mean, that's a basically a pick 'em game, so there's not really a dog, I would argue, there.
I'm down. Let's put Ottawa in that puppy.
Yeah.
I'm in. Ottawa ML. One more play. What about you want to take the Nats and fade the Wizards?
Yeah. I mean, I'd be fine going to the grave with the Wizards not winning 4 in a row.
Yeah. Brooklyn minus 3.5. I'm in for that. Chat, 5 plays, 5 winners on this beautiful Wednesday slate. All right, don't blow your whole bankroll today. We've got Sweet 16. We've got MLB season starting up tomorrow. Be conservative today. Be targeted. All right, be responsible. But make sure you're tailing the squad routes because we're not fucking losing again. All right? 5 plays, 5 winners. Hurry up. Go, go, go. You have 1 minute. And then we have the surge stream right after this. Lock the fuck in. 5 plays, 5 winners. Seattle ML. We got the Bulls plus 2.5. Clippers minus 6.5. We got Ottawa ML on the ice. And the Nets minus 3.5 right down the street in D.C. against the Red Hot Wiz Kids. Love it. You're rushing. I don't think we're rushing, A-Holtz. I'll be honest with you. These plays were all on our best bets.
Yeah.
All right? Yeah. No rushing. Okay? Javon, do you think the Bruins win? I think that's asking while the votes come in.
I kind of do. It's just, I mean, for me, not just because I'm a fan. I'm a very unbiased fan. I don't want to fade the Lightning right now. I think they're making a serious run at the trade deadline. They made exactly the ads they want, and they're playing fantastic hockey right now. But. The Bruins getting faded off of a back-to-back with the Lightning, who pretty much rested like Braden Point and Victor Hedman against the Ducks just so they could play in this game, kind of seems like the very easy thing to do. It's like I still lean the Bruins, but I don't want to fade the Bulls.
That's fair. Chat, I dropped the link for the BTL MLB season-long Megalodon one more time in the chat. If you want to tail it, the link is right there. Cannot be easier to tell. Okay. Takes literally 2 seconds. You click on it, it takes you right into your app and you click submit. All right. Takes you right there. Lock the fuck in. Javon, it's looking like it's going to be the Clippers. Ooh, you're playing.
Clippers. Good. Clippers part 75, Trent.
Catching steam.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why not?
Harden against.
I feel like overall, the Clippers have treated us pretty well.
We have. I mean, I've picked whether it's overall just the Clippers as a team or like a couple Harden spots. I feel like I've picked them pretty well, and I have no issue going to the Clippers when they're going to play Harden's former team in Philly. Mm. Who doesn't like?
Let's go Clips. They lost to them last time. Let's see if they can get some revenge. Minus 6.5 for the squad ride. This is how we get out of piss. This is how we break the streak and we change everything. Chat, lock the fuck in. Tail the squad ride responsibly this afternoon. And stick around for the surge stream. Spoon feed Trent a winner today. He needs it. All right. Stay tapped. Stay dialed. We'll catch you guys tomorrow. Same time, same place. We'll be soon. Peace. Somebody grab me our broom ski, please. Because the boys might have just clean swept the board. And by we might, we did. Krabs, how much you think your pool bobblehead is worth? I said this when I got it. Just an AI, you know, bobblehead, just like a stock bobble, is probably worth more. I mean, they couldn't give away all these bobbles. What a joke.
We need under 5.1. There he goes. Holy shit, this is fucking huge. He ain't getting it. Motherfucker, man. What are we doing, bro? This guy is fucking massive.
How many fingers?
What? You're holding up fingers?
It's definitely the meal of a man who doesn't know what season he is. I'm not gonna lie.
We need to be able to close out games and keep leads. Don't take your foot off the gas pedal, alright?
It might be brighter now, you fucking bozo.
Can you hear it? No sound? Oh, what? Mega L's. Can you hear me through the mic right now? Oh, W's. You can't hear that sound. Oh, wait, hold on. I know what I did. Fuck, dude. I know why. Hold on. I got to play this before we go, dude.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the MLB Goat Whale. 10 racks to win 100 racks.
Call in.
I haven't seen this yet, by the way. This is my first time watching.
First time I've ever gotten a nuke.
Call in.
Oh my god. It's
leading off, Bobby Witt.
Now, Junior. From a game you attack.
Fredward J. Freeman, the workhorse. Vladdy Jr., Mr. MLB the Show. Batting cleanup, Jordan Bombs.
Oh my goodness, are you kidding me? This ball is on way out of here. They need to kick off this road trip now. Jordan sends one high, sends one deep. 15th multi-home run game of his career.
Alvarez, it's a high drive center field. Beerling's back. This game is turned upside down. Alvarez launches deep right field, and this one is gone. And the Astros walk him off in game one. Jordan Alvarez, are you kidding me?
And last but not least, Devers Hogs.
I love it. Nothing gets me more bricked than just a fat hog. What?
It's going to be a round of the Major League contract. And here is Robin Devers driving this one up high and gone. Pitch. And Devers drills it. Left center field.
To the second deck. No two to Devers, driven in the air toward left center with Mike Tauchman back at the wall, jumping up, and it's into the basket and gone. Rafi's third home run of the weekend. Three in this game. And a high fly ball to right field. Driving touches back. Watch it go, and it's gone.
Not talking 10 years ago.
Oh, tagged into right on the line. Berea back. She's gone. Into the bullpen. Rafi strikes again. Swing and a shot. Watch this one go. Goodbye. Home run, Rafi Devers. Number 8. The Red Sox just keep battling back, and they do it again. On the strength of Rafael Devers with a shot out of here. Came off the bat at 110 miles an hour.
Wait. I ended it too early. Hold on. You gotta hear this part. That is unbelievable work, boys.
It's the summer of gags and dogs.
I'm dead, dude. I don't know who edited that. Obviously, Shark Lark did the voiceovers, but Skywalker, I think, had a major part in it. Skywalker, that's fucking awesome. Thank you, boys. That was great work. All right, we're done booling around. Chat, what's good? Happy Wagon Wednesday. We're back on the Surge stream. Hope you guys are doing well. W video there to start the Wagon Wednesday, boys. Last night, tough night for the kid. I lost that fucking ladder challenge, lost fat coin. Not even going to talk about it much more. We did sweep on the books. I won 7 units. Super rare sweep for the kid. We love that. That entry that I cooked yesterday, the 6-man, we took Gensel point. He had 1,000,000 SOG, 0 points. That sucked. And De'Aaron Fox, dude, that guy works for Prize Picks. Had 2 points at halftime, or at 16 at halftime. Finished with 18, dude. That was disgusting. That dude is literally a Prize Picks employee, bro. What was that? What was that? SGA also getting hooked for the taco last night. Both these guys last night, I said it was a mega max. They both full faded. They both chalked everybody. McKinnon had 3 shots in the first 5 minutes of the game. Finished with 4. Can't make it up. Perfect game script too. And it never came. It never came. I don't know how that happened. They were losing. And we didn't get that 5th SOG. Yeah, -500 Curry. All right, let's get surgical today, boys. We need it. We need it. Click this link and get in here. We got a full ass queue. If you got a dip early, let me know and I'll get to you. But let's just start it off. Going down the list here, I'm going to go with my guys. I mean, Adam's got Whales. It's your boy DG, who's 6-0 right now. Adam's got Whalers. What's good, brother? It was always Zion yesterday.
Always. All right, man. Today's a tough one to choose. Like, we got just heaps of props. So, luckily, Mitchell Robinson got ruled in. And I'm going to take Isaiah Hartenstein under PRA today. It's at 21, bumped down from 21.5. I believe there's a couple. I think Burks is going to play. But Mitchell Robinson will play. Isaiah is probably going to get closer to 20, 25 minutes. Huge spread, you know, just in a nasty game. But when Robinson's playing and Hartenstein's in the game, like, his minutes are low. His production is low. He's fully greened out. I just love this spot right now. So we're taking under his PRA today. It's not a normal thing I usually take, but out of everything, this is the one that really I feel confident in.
Did Podzmenski end up going under fantasy?
He did. Yeah. He did. Yeah. 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 And my 6-man almost hit. I had the DNP and then Curry didn't do his turnovers. It was kind of an F play. Curry's up again for that same prop today versus the Magic. I don't know. I might just to grab it. But 2.5 turnovers, he's fully read it out, and he's 7 out of 10 versus the Magic. So
did he go over?
No, he only had 1 turnover. He had a shitty game. I mean, you watched it.
Yeah, yeah. all right.
But, all right, Hardenstein under PRA today. Smash spot.
Let's go, dude. Good luck. Appreciate you, Whalers.
Let's get it.
We'll be C's. Wait, did DG lose yesterday? DG, bro, what's good?
Yeah, bro. Curry fucked me over, man. I had Curry over 25 and a half, bro. Yeah, bro. It's crazy out here. I had Curry over 25 and a half.
That's unbelievable, shit. Dude.
Disgusting. It's disgusting.
It's all right.
Today we're going to go to the Minnesota Timberwolves -8. First half. Minnesota Timberwolves -8 first half. Get in, get out. I think they blast the Detroit Pistons at home today. Cade Cunningham might not even play. We're just talking about one the best rated defense in the league going against one of the worst teams in the league. It's just destined for a disaster. And we're just going to go with the Timberwolves -8 first half.
Okay. All right. Let's go, DG. T-Wolves -8 first half.
Yes, sir.
All right. Let's bounce back, dude. Fuck Curry.
Fuck Curry, man.
All right, dude. We'll be seeing. Peace. Someone said, where's Prendy? I got him right here. Quick peep at the leaderboard really fast. Forgot to do that to start. A-Sim does it again with his tennis play, and I actually tailed it, and we turned green. W-A-Sims. And we got Putz, who's dialed the fuck in right now. It's your boy DG. Needs to qualify with a couple more plays. Big play Bob, 8-1 right now, sitting at top of the leaderboard. He needs one more play to qualify. But let's keep it rolling. Let's go with, who did I say? Oh, Prendy. Prendy in the sum room. What's up, dude?
What's up? How we doing?
Good, man. Good.
Today, I got Jamal Murray over 22.5 points, projected 24.57 points. I like this line against the Suns, who can't guard the point guard position. He's hit this line in 6 of his last 9 matchups versus the Suns, including the playoffs. Nuggets are going to look to win this game after they lost in OT last time they played. And he's hit this line in four of his last five home games. So give me Jamal Murray.
Fuck De'Aaron Fox, bro. That dude's a bum.
Dude, I don't know what that was. That was a horrible. I had the Kings winning that, and just like they looked good until like the end of the third, and then that was it. But bounce back today, Jamal Murray.
Jamal Murray, W play, brother. Let's get it.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it. Be seen.
Be seen. Be seen. W vibes today, boys. I was feeling sick yesterday. I feel much better today. I'm gonna go to Brock D and Easy Jari. Brock D, what up, bro?
What's up, Trent? How you doing?
Doing great. Chad, it's also Fruity's birthday today. Make sure to send your condolences to Fruity J. Freeman.
Happy birthday, Fruity. I've been feeding cake. I gave Canes and Reg yesterday a shit bet. -1.5 shit bet. -2.5 shit bet. I've lost like 7 in a row on stream. But you know what we're going to do? We're going to get it back with the best sport on earth, and we're going to go to baseball. We're going to go to the first game tomorrow. We're going to take Rhys Hoskins over 1.5 hits, runs, RBIs.
Wow.
I love this spot. Facing a lefty tomorrow if the game plays, but I know I won't be able to give it on because it starts at 10 o'clock my time.
Okay.
I really like it.
Okay. You're going with Rhys Hoskins tomorrow. Let's go, Brock D.
Yep. Let's have a day, right, everybody.
Let's have a day, dude. Appreciate you, man.
Yep.
We'll be seeing. Chat, you know what I fucking meant, dude. Not his condolences, okay? Send him happy birthday, would you? All right, who'd I say I was going next? Easy Jari outside. What's up, Jari?
Yo, have fallen the last two straight. Started 7-0. We're now 9-5. Need a resurge. I'm going back to Kawhi, just his points. He had 20 last game versus Philadelphia. They're playing this game in Philadelphia. Kawhi is the glue to the team that turns it up when everyone else lacking, so I think he goes out to them.
Facts. All right, Kawhi over points at what number?
23.5.
23.5, Jari. Bounce back spot. He sold last time. We're getting it back tonight.
Yeah, he owes us.
Yes, he does. Appreciate you, homie. We'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. Chat, I think we're getting good plays right now. I feel it. I'm going Yeti. I'm going Hardy Picks. Yeti, what's good?
What's good, buddy? Hey, you know, a lot of people are hitting a little bumps in the roads all of a sudden. I'm myself included. Hey, good thing is baseball starts. And as a guy once said, that's my real sport.
That's my best sport.
So the Kings suck. They just got rickrolled at home. They don't want it. You know who else doesn't want it? The freaking Hawks, man. They don't want it. Give me DeJounte Murray under 26.5 points. No sell job. They just don't want it.
Wow. Fading Murray just because he doesn't want it.
That's right.
Against the Blazers. Portland.
Yeah, at home.
Okay.
And then this Portland squad, I mean, they're young and they've got nothing to play for, and they've just been playing hard lately too. And the Hawks have just – yeah, they beat the Celtics, but, like, that was a fluke game. They're down by 30. They're going to – this is going to be a boring game, and Murray ain't scoring 27.
Okay. All right. DeJounte under 26.5 for Yeti Express.
That's right, buddy.
All right. Good shit, Yeti. Lock in, dude. Let's have a day.
Later, buddy.
BCs. We got room in queue if you want to get in here, bro. I'm going to go Hardy Picks, Turner Mac. Hardy, what up?
How we doing?
Good to see you.
I won't be able to get on stream tomorrow. I'll be too busy watching all the games instead. But I wanted to come on and give you something that's on Prize Picks already for the MLB. Two-legger. So Josh Bell over his 1.5 hits, runs, and RBIs. He's a switch hitter that they traded for in Miami. And he's had really good at-bats against Keller. I think this is a great spot for him to put up that. And then the other one, I'm going back to that Brewers game. Not Rhys Hoskins. I'm going William Contreras. He is mashing. And last season was his first season actually starting at catcher, and he had his best season of his career, and he's hitting like over 350 against left-handed pitchers. So I really like that 1.5. One last thing, if I can say it, on my Twitter, I'm doing a jersey giveaway for MLB opening day. It'll come straight shipped to your house from Golden.
Wow.
Look on my Twitter for all the details for that.
Hardy Picks on Twitter.
Yep.
All right, chat, tap in. He's giving away a free jersey. Don't miss out, bro. Hardy,
yep.
Lock in, dude. Big season ahead.
100%. Peace
Let's
out.
Let's get it, dude. We'll be seized. Appreciate you, homie. Chat, Hardy's legit, bro. There's no phony baloney jersey giveaway. All right. All right. I'm gonna go Turner Mac. What's good, Turner?
What's happening, Trent? How we doing?
Doing good, man. Steph over RA gets hooked. I fucking bet.
Yeah, it was ratchet. I didn't even think it had a chance, and then he kind of got close at the end. But whatever. We move on. Today, I got a Rashawn Holmes over rebounds and assists. I think it's at 16.5. And now you're probably thinking, like, man, we haven't bet on this dude all season. I have not. He was only averaging, like, 13 minutes a game the entire year. And now all of a sudden he's averaging 28 minutes a game over his last eight games. So it looks like they're getting him more involved. And if you take a look at the prize picks, I mean, it's on the popular tab. It's as green as it gets. He's been feasting over these last four games. And, I mean, I'm just going to play it and find out if it's going to keep going. It's obviously a little sketch because he's been rat shit all year. But pretty soft matchup against Brooklyn, close spread. If he's playing 28 minutes, I mean, I don't see how he's not grubbing 10 boards, 10 points, and it soars. So okay. That's what I'm going with.
Rashawn Holmes PRs from Turner Mac in a bounce back spot.
Yes, sir. Let's get it.
All right, dude. Appreciate you, man.
Appreciate you, Liv. We'll be seeing.
We'll be seeing. You know we'll be seeing. You know we'll be seeing. If you have to go early, let me know. I'm going to go with Booker Prime's got to bounce. Let me get Rizzy Fears in his car and then book it with Primer and Nahan. What's up, Rizzy Fears?
What up, Trent? How we doing, man?
Doing great, dude. Nice play.
All right. So Steph hit. The turnover went under.
Yep. You're locked.
Yeah, man. We on fire. Also gave out a six-piece yesterday to the community on Twitter, man. They loved that yesterday. It was nice. I'm going to give out another one today on Twitter. But right now I'm going to give you another play today. I'm 6-2. Am I in the top 10 at least now? 6-2 or not?
Let me check. Let me hear the play while I look.
I'm just trying to crack that. I don't want to run it back, but that Steph turnover 2.5 is up there again. The last five games, Orlando Magic's forcing one turnover to point guards. Steph's coming back. It's a big game again. Got to try to win. I'm running it back with Steph. I'm like, look, Steph, just do it again, Steph. Just control the ball, Steph. Okay. I'm running it back with Steph under 2.5 turnovers again. It's up there on Prize Picks again. So I'm running it back. I'll drop a six-piece. I know you don't check DMs, but do you want that shot autograph or not, man? You gotta give me a spot to ship that thing.
Yes. I got you. Send me another DM at the top of my DMs, please, so I can see it.
All right, cool. All right, sounds good, man. Under Steph Curry 2.5. Nice sweep yesterday, though. I saw that. That's good shit, man.
Let's go, Fears.
All right, brother. All right.
We'll be seized, brother.
Stay hot.
Stay locked. We'll be seeing.
Oh, wait. What rank was I?
I totally forgot. Fucking Skywalker, can you find it, bro? I can't find it.
Just Skywalker. Let me know in his chat. I'll be in the chat.
All right, word. GG.
All right, brother. I'll see you.
NBC. He's 7, rumor has it. Wow. No, he's 7. Holy shit, Rizzy Fears. All right, book it with Primer with the presentation. Primer.
How are we doing? How about the Dallas Stars covering the 1.5 on the puck line? They covered 2.5, and the Mavs got it done. The vibes are immaculate. I woke up this morning, bricked up, and a positive attitude, just so happy. It's a great time to be alive, and it's a great time to be a Dallas sport fan. I have my MLB season-long entry today. Corey Seager, 30 home runs. It's happening. Marcus Semien, 168 hits. It's happening. El Bombi, Adolis Garcia, get ready, 98.5 RBIs. Nasty Nate Uvalde, under 3.83 ERA, and then we got to throw another someone in, and we'll let you do all Rangers. So Christian Yelich at 68.5 RBIs, I think that's just too low. He went over last year. The Brew Crew, they're going to be going wild. No book plays. I'm saving all of my units for a maxer tomorrow. You already know what that is on. The open spot lay. Should have thrown the Mavs on there plus chicken yesterday. Still love to see it.
Oh, my God. Are you going to be at any of the games this weekend?
I'm going to go Saturday. Okay. I'm going to be at Texas Live Friday, I think, too.
I think Lauren will be there, too. So definitely.
Yeah, I saw that. That kind of might have to get some stuff going. It's going to be great vibes. Great time to be in Dallas, Fort Worth. Mavs, Rangers, Stars, Cowboys, dynasty season.
Oh, my God, dude. Dynasty seasons, indeed. Let's go, Prime. Appreciate you, bro. You too. Be seeing, man. God, he's a gem. All right, if you have to bounce for real, let me know. Vito's got to go. Corby's got 4 minutes. Vito, I need the play quick.
We're going quiet over 1.5 threes made.
Lillard was free. Good shit yesterday, bro. You're locked in right now. You're eighth right now.
I'm what?
You're in ninth place right now. 8-3-2.
Yes, sir.
All right. Kawhi, three-pointers?
Yes.
All right. Good work, brother. We'll be seeing. God, the kid gets it. I don't know how Lillard ended up cashing yesterday, but he did. Oh, it was actually like double overtime. My guy, Book of Chew number two has to go Corp and Book of Chew. Book of Chew 2 and then Book of Chew.
What up, Trent?
What's up, Chew 2?
Yeah, I'm taking Yeti over 13.5 centimeters his imprint in that couch. No, I'm just kidding. I'm taking tomorrow I'm going with the Phillies plus 105 against the Braves. It's Strider versus Wheeler. Zach Wheeler is just a big-time pitcher, man. Big games, he shows up. I'm not on the Spencer Strider train yet. I'm just going with the Phillies to get it done at home in Citizens.
Okay, Phillies ML tomorrow. Is that like a noon game?
No, I think it's 4:05 Eastern, oh, so okay. Probably 3 for you.
Okay. All right, Book of Chew 2. Can't wait for baseball, bro. Let's go. Be seeing. All right, Ahan and then Sheward. Ahan, what's up?
You asked me if Devers was hitting 33, and I told you he's being Shea. He's going to stop at 31, and you still put him in.
No, he's not. Chill. Don't say that. It's okay. You also told me that Curry was scoring 20 last night. No, I'm not bringing that up.
I thought he would score like 22, 24. I know. What it is. Today, back to the defensive squares since they've been printing. Brandon Miller over 1.5 steals plus blocks. I think he gets this on steals alone, but I'll take the prize pick square for steals plus blocks. We like those squares that are not only almost a red out rub, but they're at 1.5, and he hasn't gotten a single stop in 3 games. The Cavs, over the last 15 games, lead the NBA in passes made. Brandon Miller gets a lot of steals from bad pass turnovers. And the last time these two teams faced off was their last game. Got 0 in that game. This opened up at minus 105 in the books. It's now minus 115, minus 120. Keeps juicing to the over. So I'll take Brandon Miller over 1.5 stocks.
Okay. Did Dort get that steal? I know he got stat corrected.
I think he got it in the first 3 minutes.
He did. It
may have gotten stat corrected, and then he got another one. So
got it. That's what I was wondering. Yeah, that was a great square. Good shit. All right. We're going with Brandon Miller, steals and blocks.
Yes, sir.
Let's go, dude. Appreciate you, Ahan.
Appreciate you.
Be seeing. Yeah, it was always Dort steal. All right, Book of Chew. If you have to go early, let me know if you've been incubating for hours. Book of Chew, what up?
What up? So I guess it's me versus Prime tomorrow, seeing that it's Cubs versus Rangers and steals on the mound. But another thing. Happy birthday, Fruity. And since it's his birthday today, does that mean my boys are losing because they're playing his boys?
Yeah, for sure losing.
So do you want the bias play or you want my disgusting play? I'll let you pick.
Whatever's green, Chew.
All right, you know what? I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to change it up because I know everybody's going to be like, oh, here we go. So if you want prize picks, Aaron Gordon, last 5, read it out. Aaron Gordon over a 3. Last time he played Phoenix, he hit at least 1 3. So all we need is 1 3 out of him. Maybe we'll get lucky and we'll get a first basket, Aaron Gordon 3. So give me Aaron Gordon over a 3. BC and Trent, always a pleasure. Happy birthday, Fruity and Javon. Thank you for the subs yesterday.
Chewy, you're the GOAT, brother. Let's have a day.
Yes, sir. BC and Trent.
We'll be C's. Let's go. Adam got Wales with a 5 gifted subber. Let's do it, dude. Appreciate the love. I'm going DJ Fitz quitting locks. DJ Fitz, what's up, dude?
What's good, brother? What's good, man?
Not much, dude. Trying to get some coin up.
Fuck the Stags yesterday. I got you one well, but let me pitch it. It's the Orlando Magic first half minus 1.5.
Okay.
But has anyone give you a ladder play on the – so, like, a ladder play specifically for the leaderboard? So, say I give you the Orlando Magic minus 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5. Could that count as, like, Orlando Magic minus 1.5. They're 8-2 in their last 10 at home, and their defense – the Warriors are coming off the back-to-back, and their defense is just going to lock them up. I like them here at home. 8-2 in the last 10.
So. Magic first half minus 1.5.
Yes, sir. Right. Can you hold it up today, baby? Let's catch.
Let's climb, baby. Appreciate you rolling through.
Yes, sir, brother.
BCs. Fitz stays trying to find loopholes, man. Quentin Locks, everybody in chat was bitching about Pod's bagels, and he bageled. So you guys owe him an apology.
I'm not gonna lie, I was sweating that out as well.
Me too. But I don't know how he didn't end up going over, but we take those.
Yeah, he didn't even attempt another shot.
Wow.
I got another under. Grady Dick under 3.5 rebounds.
That is so surgical, bro. What are you seeing in Grady Dick under boards?
He's under this line in 8 out of the last 11 games, averaging 2.6 rebounds per game, despite averaging 31 minutes a game. That's because they got a lot of injuries, things of that nature. The Knicks, very good rebounding team, second fewest rebounds of opposing teams in the last 30 games. Second lowest total out of the slate tonight. So it's going to be a slow-paced game, fewer possessions. He's only been averaging 6.5 rebound chances in the last 9 games since becoming a starter. So he's going to have to get 4 of those, converted about 62%. It was at minus 110, and it got bumped to minus 130 after the what was it? Who got ruled in?
Couldn't tell you.
What was his name for the Knicks? Anyways.
Yeah. Fucking Hartenstein or whatever. Or no.
No, it was drawing a blank.
Yeah, me too.
But you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. But yeah, I like the under here.
Robinson. There Robinson. It is. Yeah. Yep. All right, Grady Dick underboards, huge play here for Quentin Locks. 12-3 on the leaderboard, looking to go 13-3.
Appreciate it, man.
Let's do it, dude. Stay locked. Appreciate you, man. Be seeing. Chat, you doubted Quentin Locks yesterday, but you tell the same people every time because they fucking win me coin. If you have to bounce, let me know. Hella goats in here that are incubating. Elliot has to dip. Elliot, I took fucking Gensel to get a point, not even an assist, dude.
Shit wager. Today, got to be quick. Tage Thompson is scoring a goal. He's plus 155 on FanDuel. He has 6 goals in 4 games against the Senators. We know the Senators allow a shit ton of goals. And I think it's going to be high scoring. The over is juiced to like minus 120. So I got to go. GG's.
All right. GG, brother. We'll be seeing. Keep it moving. W tempo and peace. Let's go to my Gajman intern Rav, Nikki Zims. Intern Rav, Mavs last night were a mega, mega, mega max.
Let's fucking go, Trent. You know what, though? I got fucking hooked on triple-double for Doncic because they pulled him. So
Moose.
Annoying.
Moose.
But anyways, you got a good tempo, so I'll be quick. I'm also on Magic minus 1.5 first half.
Really?
They've been super hot since the All-Star break, 12-4. Fourth best net rating since then. Best defensive rating. Warriors just played less yesterday, and I love fading back-to-back teams on back-to-backs. The Warriors rely heavy in the three, but the Magic are, like, top in the league at defending the three. They've been playing Draymond at the five recently, which is super small ball. They can't keep doing that against the Magic, and if they do, they're going to get burned. They really have matchup advantages everywhere, so I'm going to go Magic minus 1.5 first half.
WSL job, intern Rav. You might be locked. Let's go.
I feel locked, man. It feels good.
Yeah, you might be him, bro, especially after that mega last night. All right, Magic first halfers. Let's get it, Rav.
We'll be seeing.
Rumors are swirling about SGA not playing tonight. He's kind of banged up right now. He literally talked about it last night. Nikki Zims and Rito.
Why is everyone fading the Warriors?
Because they're dog meat, brother.
Okay. All right, I was just wondering. I don't know. I was so confused with this. Paterka point. On Prize Picks. I'm in New York, so I'm going to take it on the book. But Paterka's on the second line with 2 kids, Cousins and Quinn. They're gonna light it up tonight.
Okay.
So you could take Paterka, Cousins. They're all 3 of them are on there. So, I mean, it could happen in 1 fucking goal.
Okay. Paterka right. Getting the point.
Yeah, Paterka point. We'll have a good day.
Let's go, Zims. Good yes, to sir. See you, the Nikki Zims mic, bro. I love that shit. Justin Hulkey greened out to Gobi. An oxymoron goat. What's up, Justin Hulkey?
What's up, Trent?
It's been a minute, dude. Good to see you.
Yeah. Today I got Tanner Janot over 3 hits.
Janot over 3 hits?
Yeah, he's been hitting pretty well lately. The Panthers just got 50 hits last game against... Yeah, against Boston's. A lot of those came from the forward. I got a bookie where I live from. They do special matchup prop, and he's matched up against Jakub Loko on the Bruins. and he's minus 500 to record more hit than Loco.
Holy
And
shit.
Loco can like hit four pretty easily. He's had a couple of six hits game lately. So yeah.
That's a W nugget. So you're telling me that dude that he's facing gets hit a lot of hits, but Jeannot's minus 500 to have more hits than that guy?
Yeah, and I discovered this the past few this past few week, and I hit Luke Shen yesterday. He was at three. He was a huge favorite. He hit six, I think. Braden Shen this week had two hits in the first 4 minutes, and so I keep writing the system.
W system lab work from Justin Halkey, bro. I love it.
Yeah, we'll be.
We'll be seeing, dude. Good to see you. Peace. Yeah. Peace. Chat, that might be a max. All right, we got Oxymoron and then a scary mask in queue. This should go well. Oxymoron. What's up, handsome? Brother?
Finally, you put me in a freaking whale. You finally put me in something decent, the whale.
Oh, yes, dude. Thank you.
By the way, if I put a ladder outside your house, will you climb it?
Of course.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, Golden State and Orlando both scoring 110 each for 220 over 217. Okay.
We're going the over in the Warriors game tonight.
Ready to go?
All right. Let's go, Oxymoron. We'll be seeing, brother. Bro, what? All right, DM in queue. I don't know who this guy is, but he's got a scary mask on, and it should be interesting, bro. What's up?
Oh, you know me, brother. I give you Jameson Williams, two touchdowns in the NFC Championship game. He came through, but I just got finished taking care of these pythons. Let me zoom in on that. Oh, yeah. I take care of my body because I am the king of Chatham. Now, listen, I take care of my body, and I'll take care of your pockets tonight. It's quite simple. The forecast calls for rain in Los Angeles tonight, and it'll be Desmond Bane hitting five threes in your face at plus 550. We'll be seeing.
We'll be seeing, dude. Let's fucking go. Desmond, bang me home for DM.
Bang it, baby.
All right.
One more time for y'all. Ooh, look at that.
Damn, dude. He's kind of ripped. All right, dude. Good luck.
Best of luck.
Be seeing. Dude, what in the actual fuck, bro? I'm done. I'm fucking done. All right, we got Goats Incubate, and I'm going Spencer J, Coop Eagle, Adrian, and then Rito. Rito be incubating, dude. Rav, clip that shit. What'd you do? Spencer, what's good?
Oh, what's up, man? How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
Doing all right. We're going to go Nurkic over boards on prize picks. I think it's at 10 right now, so that's a good score to get.
Okay.
Either that or Grayson Allen over 2.5 threes. Dude's shooting lights out on the road. I told you he's shooting by 50%. And then on the road and at home, he's shooting less than that, like 45, 46%.
So okay.
I'm going to stick with Nurkic tonight, okay?
All right. Nurkic rebounds over 10 for Spencer J.
Yep.
All right, dude. Good luck. Be seeing. W pen clicks. Let's go to Coop Eagle in his Rizzy corner. Coop.
What's up, Trent?
What's up, brother?
I got no ladders for you to climb, but I got a combo square. We're going back to Lori and Wembiana over 46.5 points.
Oh.
They just played a month ago. They both combined for 48. But tonight, they're the highest total on the board. Should be a very close game, 4-point spread. Both are projected to go over. Utah allows the second most points to centers. And Lori has owned the Spurs going over every time since joining Utah. So.
Okay. Markkanen combos with Wemby over 46.5.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's get it, Coop. Good shit, bro.
Yeah.
Be seeing. I think Coop is red hot right now. He is. Where did his little fire emojis go? What number? Oh, he's right here. 16. Oh, I think he lost his last pick. Uh-oh. All right, Adrian and Rita. What's up, Adrian? What's
going on, Trent? How are we feeling?
Doing good, man. How are you?
Feeling a little bit better after last night?
Feeling a little bit better, yeah.
Good, good to hear. Dimitrov comes through and cashes for us on that tennis yesterday. A little bit juice. Like I said, it was a minus 140. It was a sweat, though, so he won in the third set. I did call the games were going over, but I just liked him to win outright. I'm going two book plays again today. I like the Bulls plus three. I think they're a little bit hungover from that loss to D.C. You know, they're hanging at that ninth seed, and if they really want to be real, they got to win this game. You know, I think Indiana's going to be a little bit tired from two games in L.A., you know, a little bit hungover from that L.A. shit. So I think the Bulls get it done, plus three today. Clippers, Ty Lue came out, called him soft. It's the second time this season that he does that. I don't know if he's trying to light a fire under these guys. They can't find their identity. Everyone overhypes the Clippers so fucking much. And it's, you know, oh, man, you know, James Harden, Kawhi Leonard. Man, they can't play defense. Defense is not going to win them a championship. Defense is not going to win them these playoff games. Anyway, I still like the Clippers. Minus 5.5. I caught it last night at minus 110. They got called soft. Let's see if they're soft today.
Okay. W sell jobs from Adrian. Bulls and Clippers.
Let's get it.
Let's get it, dude. Appreciate you, man.
Take care, y'all.
We'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. You can put them down for the Bulls, Skywalker. Bulls minus or Bulls plus three W's. All right, Rito, Guru Griff, actually King of Tempo, really fast. Bam, you old brother. What's good?
It was never lighting the beam.
No, it wasn't, Bam. I trusted you. I'm joking, dude. I didn't take it, but I wanted to.
Give me Seattle money line and the CBI, I think it is.
Damn, they're still moving on, bro.
CBI final. Yeah, Seattle's kind of been rolling. They're playing High Point. High Point's pretty good. They're the one seed, but give me Seattle. They're the hotter team. So
okay. All right. Bamuel with Seattle money line, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. GG's, brother. Peace, peace, peace. Who the fuck is this guy, dude? That's a new fade spawn. We have room in queue today. If you want to come give me a play, would love to get some more, bro. Would love to get some more. Don't have enough straight bets to choose from. Rito. Hold on. Before I pull up Rito, did he do his job yesterday? Did Rito do his fucking job? I don't know. I can't find it. Rito, did you do your job?
Yes. D-Lo had 12 assists.
Oh, my God, dude. That was a max.
Yeah. Well, he had zero assists in the first quarter, and I thought it was doomed. But
wow, he had his demon. I had him in a demon square with something, and that shit smacked. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. But I got Charlie McAvoy over 2.5 hits today. Basically, he's hit in three games versus the Lightning this year with 3-4-4. Boston has the second most hits per game. Tampa has the 10th most hits per game. Boston gives up the second most hits, and Tampa gives up the 11th most hits. So I think this is going to be a very physical game, and Boston only needs one win to clinch a playoff berth. So I think this is like game of the night across all sports. He also has the most TOI among all defensemen on the Bruins. So, I mean, I think this is a boom.
Let's go, Rito. You've been dialed in this week. Stay locked. McAvoy.
Let's do it, bro.
All right. We'll be seeing, brother.
We'll be seeing, brother.
Peace, peace, peace. Rito is the only dude that can come on without getting chirped with no cam. Guru Griff, what's up, dude?
What's happening, Trent? Shout out the Mavs coming through for the Guru last night. Yep. Another thing, whoever gave that soccer play yesterday is a fucking goat. I don't know, the dude. Costa Rica, Pika, Dika, Fika. I don't know how the fuck, what league it is in. But, I mean, they were up 3-0 at halftime. I forgot that guy.
I forgot to give him his flowers, bro. That was a whale.
Yeah, shout out that guy. The guy in the mask, the DM guy showing the pythons, that was 200% Hovey. But we're moving on to the play. We're going to go late night. Nikola Jokic, the Joker, over assists and rebounds. It's at 20.5 on the green book on DraftKings. Like I said, it's minus 130. The Joker's played the Suns twice now. He's hit it at 21. I just see him getting 14 rebounds and 9 assists. 14 rebounds, 10 assists over that 20.5. Like I said, it's juicy at minus 130, but I mean, it counts.
Okay. Jokic, RA, my death beam square always. But today, you like it. Good spot. Good matchup.
good matchup against the Suns. If it's a blowout, it's a blowout. But I mean, the Suns need it. The Nuggets need it. Joker needs it. Shout out Hobie for getting in the gym.
Let's go, Guru Griff. Love the play.
You have a good day. You have a good day.
All right, we'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. W's. Chat, one requirement today. I need to hear from one W new face. I need it. I need it. So if you're in chat, you're shy about coming on, we need a W new face today. Oh, damn, it's Austin. Let me know when you're ready. Bears fan, what's up, dude?
What's up? What's up? I gave you D-Low points yesterday. It was get zero in the first quarter, but he turned up in the second half.
Yep.
Hopefully today I got you Paulo points. It's at 22.5. He's a Prize Picks employee, but
yes,
I think he's going over today. I wouldn't tell it, but I'm just giving you that.
I like the play. I have his over 40 balls for the second half of the season. Bro has zero. He's so due to have a 40 ball.
He's dropping 40 now. He dropped 27 last time he played him, and the Warriors let forward score. Like Siakam had 25 the other night. Like four different forwards on the Heat had like 10 plus last night. So I think he's going over.
All right. Let's go, Bears, man.
Yeah.
Let's get it, brother. Appreciate you. Dude, that's literally Jenks. That's Wish version of Jenks. Oh, damn, it's Austin. Jenks, that's literally you, bro. You can't even fucking deny it. Oh, damn, it's Austin. What's up, brother?
What's up, Trent? How you doing?
Good, man.
Valanciunas sucked ass yesterday. They only played him 11 minutes. So
that's
shout
the thing.
Out to MySpace for rebooting it.
Oh, they rebooted it?
Yeah, they rebooted his plays because he only played 11 minutes, but there was no like injury tag or nothing. So I don't know what the fuck happened. Like I just saw a shit ton of people on Twitter be pissed off, of course, with their right to be. But yeah, he only played 11 minutes. So luckily, PrizePicks rebooted it for us. Today we have a freaking massive slate in the NBA. And I post a lean sheet on Twitter every single slate for games, for plays I like in every single game. We're going to do something a little different this time. I'm going to let you choose left and right side of the sheet and then choose a number between 1 and 14.
All right. Let's go right and let's go 6.
All right. So you got Norman Powell over 13.5 points. Let's see. I can pull that up real quick. One second.
Norman Powell.
They're playing against Philly again. They just played, two or three days ago. In that game, he dropped 20 points on them. If you go back through his game log, he's hit this in 6 straight games against Philly. Regardless of the minutes, he plays up and down. He's their, their sixth man off the bench, if you will. I know Westbrook is back. Don't really care. He only played about 14 minutes in the last game. I think Westbrook can still do whatever he wants, but that also helps out Powell because Westbrook will be controlling the rock and dishing it out to him. He takes plenty of shots in there. He's hit this line in, what's that? It's 6 out of the last 7 games. So he's been playing really well, and that's what I got for you. Like I said, I have a big-ass lean sheet I posted on Twitter if anyone's interested in that. But, yeah, that's you chose Norman Powell over 13.5 points.
Okay, let's fucking go. Oh, damn, it's awesome.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate you, man.
I'm glad you're feeling better, Trent, and happy birthday, Rudy, and you guys have a great day.
Hey, you too, man. We'll be seeing.
Take it easy.
Peace. W vibes, bro. Chat. Why are you chirping a dude with W vibes? I don't get it. Brock D's back for seconds. Did you want to say something, bro?
My play got postponed tomorrow and got rained out.
GG.
So I'm going to give you a different play tonight on the NBA. I'm going to go with the Nuggets -7.5 against the Suns. Last time the Suns went to Denver, they won outright. I think they were a 6-point dog or whatever. I think the Suns are just ultimately really soft, and I think that they get blown out tonight. Vogel just doesn't get the guys going. They don't pass. They don't do anything right. They just lost to the Spurs last game as a 12-point favorite. I think they get bitched here, and the Nuggets cover relatively easily.
Okay, Nuggets take care of business against the Suns tonight, -7.5 at home.
Yep.
All right, let's go, Brock D.
Yeah, appreciate you bringing me back up. Thanks.
Of course. GG's, bro. We'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. I'm still requesting a W new face today. Absolutely need it. I'm not going to start cooking until I see one. We got some goats in here. Bear Bats, Sonny G. What's up, Bear Bats?
What's going on, Trent? How you doing?
Great. How are you?
Doing well. Draymond was free yesterday. Played a pretty good game, even though he scored like 4 points. Today I got Rashawn Holmes
fantasy score. I don't know. He's just been playing really well. And with Denny Avdija still out, I believe, he'll get some good minutes, a couple blocks and steals in there, and maybe 7-8 rebounds. I even have him for a double-double as well.
Okay. Okay. So, Rashawn Holmes fantasy score.
Little sketchy, but you got to go with it.
Okay. All right. Let's go, Bear Bats.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate you. We'll be seeing. I see you, bro. I will absolutely retweet that. I will absolutely retweet that. Let's go to my guy, Sonny G. What's up, Sonny?
What up? What up? Just working through the day. I really like Kucherov anytime goal. He also hasn't had a goal in three games. So I have to lean the same method I rolled last night with the two Connors. And the only Connors that scored last night were McMichael and Connor Brown. So I'm rolling anytime Kucherov goal today.
Kucherov to score.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Sonny G running it back.
Have a good day. Back to work.
Back to work. GGs. We'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. W's. Chat, are they gonna take away college player props? That's what the rumors are saying. Deadass Daros and Q. What's up, bro?
Yo, what's good?
How we doing?
Good, good. Caps, big W last night.
Big.
Going back to the ice tonight. Shit game. But I'm taking the Senators plus chicken. They're beating the rat shit Sabres tonight. Coming off two decent wins against the Oilers and the Devils. Keep that momentum going. Give me the Senators. It's ugly.
Sends ML plus chick against the rat shit Sabres.
Against the rat shit Sabres. Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Lock in, brother.
All right. Have a good day, man.
We'll be seeing. We'll be seeing. W's. Butt naked Q's, boys. Butt naked Q's. First time chatter says Trump money line. Welcome to the stream, brother. Thanks for the follow. And same with D Han V 10. Thanks for the follow, bro. Appreciate it. We got butt naked Q's, boys. Butt naked Q's. Not enough plays and some butt naked Q's. Nothing new. First two games tomorrow have been postponed. That sucks. That sucks. That's a bummer, bro. What were the two games? Oh, we got Los Santos Customs. Los Santos.
Yo.
What's good?
What's good? I'm going to make it real quick, man, before we get crazy. We taking the Wizards first quarter spread plus 1.5 versus the Nets.
Wizards That's first quarter spread?
Yeah, plus 1.5 versus the Nets.
Okay. All right.
I would give a sales job, but I'm afraid.
Yeah, we're about to start.
Yeah, But there we go.
All right, we'll be C's goat. all right, we got UPS Paul in here, an absolute legend in the community. Paul, how we doing, man? We miss you.
I miss everybody, but you know, big things to focus on life. Smiling, we're all here. It's real simple. Kermo was a huge Orioles fan. He always wanted to make it to Camden Yards. So in honor of him tomorrow, Orioles run line plus 110. Book that shit. Let's go.
We're fucking nuking it. We're nuking it. Who are they playing? You know, off the top of your head?
Your rat shit team, the Angels.
I will happily be placing that wager in honor of Hermo, bro.
There we go. I'm going to get back to slanging boxes.
Yes, sir. We'll be C's. Much love, Paul. Have a great day.
You too, brother. Peace.
Peace, peace, peace. Of course they're playing the Ratchet Angels, bro. Are you kidding me? All right, we have some goats spawning in. Let's go. B-Camp in the Sunday Greens. Someone said, need the link. Here's the link. Get in here. B-Camp, what's good?
Not much, Trent. Been a minute, so I figured I'd hop back on while I got some time.
Absolutely, bro. Big weekend this weekend, dude.
Yes, especially for me and my Boilermakers, man. I'm a little nervous, but.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, breaking news. I'm fading the fuck out of them the rest of the tournament.
I'll take that.
All right,
we're sticking with CBB today. We're going to the NIT Seton Hall UNLV game. We're back in Seton Hall here, but I'm going to go Kadari Richmond over 15.5 points. He's had four pretty shit games recently here in this tournament. But I think today is the day. I don't see a lot of threes being taken here against UNLV. I think they can take advantage of the paint a little bit. And Kadar is your guy to do that. He's not taking your threes. Like I said, he's four red out of the four of the last five. He averages, I can't remember now, but it's over this number. And I just see him having a great game. He was a huge facilitator last game. He had 15 rebounds and a bunch of assists. I just don't see him doing that today. So,
okay. All right.
Points.
Kadari Richmond over points.
You got it.
Who does he play for again?
Seton Hall.
Seton Hall, that's right. Okay. And that game's tonight?
Yes, that's the early game, 7 o'clock or whatever, 7:30.
All right, B-Camp in the Sunday greens. Let's go, brother.
We'll be seeing. See you for baseball Peace. Tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Peace, homie. W's. God, I can't wait for baseball, bro. Link in chat if you need it. Link is in chat if you need it. We got Ron Mux coming off. It's not even Ron's fault, man. I mean, what the fuck happened to the Leafs and the Avs last night? Bullshit.
Yeah, it was tough. Yeah, we usually don't full fade the Bozo packs. I definitely chased on the Avs a few times, so that was a little rough. But, you know, they've been so good to us this year, so it's all good. Got another Bozo pack for you today. Going to do one NBA, one NHL. Going to take the Clippers money line. Going to pair it with the Lightning plus 1.5 against the Bruins today. Lightning haven't played since Sunday. Bruins on a back-to-back. I just think the Lightning are going to keep this game close. Should be a good game. I could see overtime in this game. So going to take the plus 1.5 and then the Clippers. I tried to not take the Clippers today, but I don't think there's a better spot to take them than today. I think the money line's a safe play to take them. So I'll be laying that minus 120 on the Bozo pack for one unit.
Okay. Lightning plus 1.5 and Clips ML. Love it, dude.
Yes, sir. Let's muck today. Let's get back in the green.
Yes, sir. Let's muck, brother. Stay goated, Ron.
All right, man. Have a great day. Appreciate it.
You too. We'll be seeing. Let's go. Chat, have you seen these new Prize Picks shits? Holy fuck. On Prize Picks, they've got so many new categories. Wow. Wow. Go look at that shit. They got home run demons? Oh my God. They have home run demons. They've got stolen bases, doubles, nerfies, walks, not for the pitcher, for the batters. Holy schnoz, bro. All right, we got Luke and Banker better. And RBIs demons. Oh my God, dude, I'm about to lose so much coin. Luke, what's up?
What's going on, Trent? How you doing?
How's it going, man?
It's going pretty good, man. Excited for the big game against the Rockets today.
Big game against the Rockets. No SGA.
No SGA. Sad days, but I mean, Rockets are they're on a win streak, which I can't hate, but they're still pretty mid in my opinion.
Yeah.
And I have a play for the OKC Thunder, which should still come out with a win without Shea.
Yeah.
I'm not seeing a line for it right now because I think they're updating everything now that Shea's out, but the over for Chet's points, whatever it is, he's going to hit it. They still got the backup, what's his name, Jock Longdale or something.
Longdale.
But he is not stopping the boy Chet. It's going to be J-Dub and Giddy just facilitating the offense, looking for lobs, looking for the back doors. Like, this is Chet, J-Dub's big night, I think, to shine without Chet, and he should hit this over for his points, for, like, easily.
I love it. Great sell job, dude. Chet points at what? You don't know because they took.
Yeah, it's not on there right now. Whatever it is, he should hit. And they're on a 9-game win streak, too. OKC has ended many win streaks. We have the Rockets pick right now. We can't let them get to 10. There, it's over for us. So
facts,
we should come off the dub.
Okay. W sell job, Luke. I like it.
Thanks, brother.
All right. We'll be seeing. W's. Remulo, shut up, bro. Banker better. Exactly what I thought was going to happened. It's just comedy, bro. It's comedy. Goats are muted, though. Goats are muted. Tens. We'll bring them back in a second. We'll bring them back. Someone needs the link in chat. Here it is right here. Banker betters? He'll be back. Dylan Hanvey? Potential W news? No. You've been on here before, right?
Hey, what's up? What's going on, Trent?
How's it going, dude? First time?
Been on here for like 2.5 years. My first time on stream.
Let's fucking go.
Tonight, let's go Rockets money line tonight. I like them. I hate to do it to you, man. Going for 10 straight tonight. Jay's out. I think we get it done. 10 straight. Push for the playoffs. Late season push. Let's get it done tonight.
Okay, Dylan. Good luck, man. Nice to meet you. W new face, brother.
Yes, sir, man. Appreciate you, Trent.
Let's have a day. We'll be seeing. With all due respect, I'm playing the fuck out of it. Surgical Shane. Are you still undefeated, bro? Surge Shane? I don't think so. What's up, dude?
Trent. It was looking really good last night. I thought I was going to go to 4-0, but Georgia and Ohio State just decided to make every single three-point shot they put up.
So, dude, I saw some plus EV bozos on Twitter nuking that over, and yeah. I was like, fuck, man, that might be chalk.
Yeah, no, I mean, it was right from the tip-off, they just made so many shots. It was dead pretty much right away. But I did call the England-Belgium draw yesterday. I called
wow.
It ended up being a draw.
We knew that was
that kind of feeling. I had a pretty good feeling for those kind of games. A big soccer fan, but I'm going back to college basketball slate today for you. And actually, I'm looking at the number now. So I got terrible COV on this, which kind of stinks. But Seattle High Point is the CBI championship game tonight down in Florida. The over-under is now 149.5, which I like even better now because you can get that key number at 150. I'm going over 149.5. These are two teams that don't have good defense whatsoever. High Point also is one of the best offenses in the country. And I think that this game could end like 80-80 tonight and like clear that by 10 points. So okay. I'm going with the over in that game tonight. But yeah, I wish my undefeated streak would continue, but it didn't last night, obviously. But
it's all right, man. We bounce back with some buckets in exactly. High Point in Seattle.
Exactly. We'll be seeing, bro.
We'll be seeing, bro. Appreciate you. Stay locked. Peace. All right, let's go back. Dude, Indiana State last night, boys. Did anybody see that cash? It was insane. Banker better, let's try again. What's up, dude?
Can you hear me?
Yep.
All right, perfect. Yeah, we should have known when everybody was on Fox yesterday that it was cake, and then they did the discount taco thing. I shut the TV off, went to bed.
Dude, it's insane how cursed the tacos are, bro. It's crazy.
I'm typically one to not take them, just not bias towards them, just stay away from them. But they baited us yesterday. They got us. Oh, they rebooted it, so it didn't matter. But whatever, we move on. Today I've got Nick Richards under rebounds and assists. He hasn't sniffed this line the last few games that he's played him. Jared Allen, I think he's going to be able to dominate him down low. Just it's under season. I don't know why I came in and gave Fox over points. I've been sticking to unders. They've been cashing. Nick Richards, rebounds, assists, under.
That could be so sharp. Banker better. That's just like a random ass square. I would never go and fucking click this. This is why we have the surge stream.
Green.
All right, green. Let's get it, Banker. Bounce back. Be seen. Chat, you buying in? Oh, Banker bounce back. Nick Richards, under. Under season is indeed in full swing. My guy, Papa Putz, 3+3 equals many, many goals.
What's up, brother? How we doing? Yeah, gave you an over and it cashed. Of course, I'm the GOAT. No worries.
And I tailed and nuked it.
I'm so proud of you, man. We're getting back those coins from Vegas. Fuck Vegas. Yes. It's all about us. Listen. 5 years sober yesterday. I hit a +1,000 parlay and a +15 on parlay play. So you know what? We'll take it. Wow. If you look at your messages, you could have cashed with me, but no, leaving me on delivered like my bitches. So it's all good. But today we're going with Tampa Bay money line. Okay. So they're playing Boston. Boston's on a back-to-back. Tampa's got to keep winning. I mean, listen, I know the Red Wings are 6 points behind from the wild card spot. But if Tampa starts losing and they start winning, it starts getting stressful. Someone might snag that wild card spot. So Tampa has to keep going. So big win for Tampa. Big place for Tampa to win against Boston to prove themselves as a playoff team tonight. Let's take Tampa money line. And if you want my lean for Ottawa and Buffalo, dog shit teams, but they leave goals in. You want to hit the over on that one, that's for sure.
Okay. But
that's the play for today, Trent.
Bolt's money line is the PRB, and he leaves the over in the other game.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And as we would say, BCN.
BCN. Peace, brother. Much love. Dude's goated, man. Dude's goated. All right, chat. Lock the fuck in, bro. Chat, before I bring him up, are we putting him in the slip regardless of what the square is? I'm talking ASIM. Are we putting him in? Let's all agree that we're putting it in. Yeah, we're putting it in. ASIM, my goats. ASIM is currently 12-2-1. A win today would be massive for the kid. What's up, brother?
Nothing much. Doing well. Finally, the curse is broken, I guess.
We got it. We got it.
Yeah, now I'm going back to Pagula over games on Prize Picks. I like this matchup here again to be tight because she's playing Alex Androva, who just got a huge win. She just upset number one woman in the world. And she looked really good in that match. She was serving really well. And throughout this whole tournament, she was also stepping in. She hits pretty flat. And she hit a bunch of winners stepping in off their return. And I think the reason why this match is going over and a bit closer is because Pagula, she does pretty well when players are just hitting consistent pace. So kind of a good matchup versus Alex Androva. And, like, both of them are serving very well, which is kind of what you need for an over here. Like, last match, watch Pagula. She just saved every break point in that second set, which is actually why I kind of pushed the first day this week. But, yeah, I have this going three sets.
Three sets for Pagula. Over games, what is it, 21 and a half?
It's 22.
22.
Yeah, it got bumped already, so...
Was it ever at 21 and a half on Prize Picks?
Yeah, it was. I actually saw Alex Monahan put it in a slip.
We're letting the plus TV bozo steal your fucking play.
I mean, no, I mean, like, I mean, I'm pretty sure Rybakina was plus TV because she got bumped yesterday. It was 21. It was 21 and a half, like, before the match started. So it's not a big deal.
Okay. People in chat who be tailing this. If you're going to bitch about the play, at least know what you're bitching about because all of you were saying shit was chalked. You don't know tennis, chat. Neither do I, but we're tailing. Let's fucking go, Pagula.
Over I mean, tailing. It's not chalked. Like, I mean, I think, like, people, if you look at the score and you see, like, a 6-2 or 6-3 first set, like, you don't need 13 games or 12 games of first set. You just need them to split sets. It's just like, yeah, it doesn't look good first set, but really the second set is all that matters. For like facts. The sweat facts.
All right, ASIM, you're literally him. Let's run it back. Pagula game, shit screen.
Yep, have a good one.
All right, GG's. Fuck, chat. Dude is so cracked. I wish I could be that good at something. All right, hold on. Let me put Jewel on charger before I go. This dude in queue. Sorry, on air sign. You're getting the bump. W. Fuck, chat. Are we tailing ASIM's POD? Owen Sheaf. What's up, brother?
What's going on? How are we doing?
Doing great. How are you?
Good, man. So I got a hometown bet for you tonight. Has High Point Moneyline been talked about at all?
No. We've heard Seattle. That's it.
Okay. So I'm going to go against that a little bit. Personally, I go to High Point. I've watched damn near every game this year. And I think they should be favored in this one. It's the CBI final down in Florida. So I got some stats to back it up. So High Point actually shoots the most free throws in all of Division I and makes the most free throws in all of Division I. And Seattle allows the 261st most free throws in the country. So I think High Point's going to get to the line a lot tonight. Also, they're a top 10 offense in the country. As I said, I think they should be favored tonight. They've kind of rolled through the CBI. Well, they won yesterday by one. They were up 16 in the second half, so, like, should have been a lot more than that. Actually had a disgusting beat on them yesterday. But anyways, I like them tonight, plus 100 money line. I think it's pretty good odds for it, to be honest. So I love that. I got 1.5 units on it tonight.
1.5 units on High Point money line.
Yeah, and it's satisfying because it's plus 100. So it's just straight up, you know?
Yep. Love that.
Appreciate you.
Let's go, Owen. Appreciate you, homie.
All right. We'll be seeing.
Be seeing. Let's go. MTSQ. I'm requesting that I get Javon and Krabs' card because I'm tired of missing out on their plays, bro. I'm tired of missing out on them. I'm requesting them. We got a butt naked Q. If you want to come give me a whale, we still got some time. Chat, quick nuggets though. Any thoughts? Any plays that you guys are liking so far that you've heard? Any plus EV nuggets I need to know about around town? What's going on over on the Twitter sphere, bro? What's going on Twitter sphere, dude? You know what's the worst thing in the whole world? Is when I'm in sulking in quail urine. Sulking in quail. And I go and literally everybody with a Twitter account posting green check marks. Everybody on Twitter is Jeffrey Bezos. Except me is what it feels like every single night. Every night. I feel like I'm the only one in quail, dude. It's insane. I wish people post their losses more. We got Groovy in queue. Groovy?
Yo, what's up, Trent?
What's up, dude?
First time, man.
Let's go.
So, I'm going to go with my Bulls tonight. I'm going to do Vooch over 10.5 rebounds. Mm. The last two times he paid the Pacers, he had 12 and 17. Pascal Siakam's going to be guarding DeMar DeRozan and Torrey Craig a lot, so he's going to be pulled out the inside. I'm not worried about Miles Turner rebounds. So, I'm going to go with Vucevic over rebounds tonight.
Okay. Vucevic boards from Groovy, first timer.
Yes, sir.
All right. Nice to meet you, bro.
You too, man.
Good luck. GGs. We'll be seeing. Chat, yesterday, let's all agree, I was dialed in yesterday cooking up that entry. It obviously didn't go to plan, but it was close. It was close. I'm getting the same vibes today. I feel like we're smacking. If I would have left Gunsel's SOGs in there like I originally wanted to, and then you guys talked me off it, yeah, I'm blaming it on you. We would have been 5 of 6 because Fox is a Prize Picks employee, and that was never hitting. But it would have been 5 of 6. Kells, come on. Come on, don't call me out for that shit. Yes, we get a noble sell job and a Javon POD. Let's go. This guy is spamming Lamonte Wade half a base on multiple platforms, not only in chat, in my Twitter DMs, on my Twitter posts. This guy wants that shit to be nuked. I don't know why. All right, let's get a noble POD. Noble, what's good? Oh, there he is.
Yo, what's good, Trent? How you living, boss?
Great. What was your play yesterday?
D'Angelo Russell's points.
And it smacked.
Smacked air. You know the vibes. All right. So I got you today. I haven't looked at the spreadsheet, so I don't know if it's been pitched already. Has anybody pitched Jared Allen today?
No.
All right. Let's get it. Jared Allen over 16.5 points. They play the Hornets today. The Hornets give up the third most points per game to centers. Jared Allen just played them last game, which you could be worried on a back-to-back night, but I kind of like that. He had 17 of them in that matchup, so he went over that total. He's averaging 17.8 over the last 5 games. Can't be too mad at that, but he also gets off against the Hornets as a whole. In his last 6 games against them, he's gone over this in 5 of the 6 games. The only time he went under is when he played 14 minutes, only had 4 points, probably left that game due to an injury. So I like this situational spot here because we've seen that the Cavs, even though they've got Mitchell, they've got Garland, they're willing to feed Jared Allen in situations that make sense for him to grow up. He's eaten against all the teams that are ranked in the bottom 5 against centers this year, like the Wizards, like the Pacers. And here we have another favorable matchup here for him against the Hornets, who give up the 5th most points per game. So I like Jared Allen here to get 16.5 points as the pick of the day.
Okay. Noble targeting Jared Allen against the Hornets. Not a bad idea. 17 points on PP. Noble, I like it, dude. W sell job.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you, man. Can we see the leaderboard real quick? I didn't see the update. What are we looking like here?
Yeah. Where's great. Noble at these days?
We're 6th, or we're 10th on the other one, and then we're 6th on the 10-play leaderboard. That's what matters, the 10-play leaderboard.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So, yep. All right, bro. I'll see you tomorrow, man.
Let's go, Noble. Appreciate you, man. Okay. Be seeing. Noble creeping up. Noble creeping up. Who's going to get it, bro? We got a long came Holly. What was your play yesterday? Middle. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? That whole game, I swear, was super, super, super sketch. Especially Giannis, but I didn't know Middleton got hooked too.
Yeah, he just couldn't make a bucket. Double overtime and you didn't hit your line. That's just terrible.
That's terrible.
But today I like Jaren Jackson for 27.5 PRA. Mm. I think he can get closer to 30. Memphis versus Lakers, home game for Memphis, 4-point spread. Lakers are on a back-to-back. Anthony Davis is now ruled questionable. Ooh. So if, I don't know, some inflammation in his leg or something. So if he doesn't play, I think that's even better for Jackson. He's had like 14 and 16 field goal attempts the last time he's played them. So I think as long as he can make his buckets. I also like center / power forwards against them. Giannis in his overtime, he had 29 points, 21 rebounds, and 11 assists with the double overtime. So I'm thinking it'll stay close, and hopefully Jaren Jackson can come through.
I feel like this is a buy low spot on him too. It feels like a low line considering he soared under in his last game. I feel like this is a good spot to take him.
Right. I wish they had him for fantasy because he loves to get those blocks and steals, but they don't have that. No. So I'm going with the PRA.
Okay. Let's go, Holly. Bounce back today with JJJ over PRA.
Yep.
Let's go. Appreciate you.
Yep. No problem.
Have a great day. Be seeing. Be seeing. W. Yo, Pickett Putts. Are you in queue, bro? How are you not giving me your play? Hold on. Let me grab my Jerry June. Hartenstein under PRA. Pegula over game. Jamal points. Dude, that. Adam's got Wales. Might have just done the homework. He might have. That's. Can you DM me that, please, so I don't lose that? All right. We got Woe on Deep and Crap. Let's get a BTL sandwich. How about that?
Yeah. Sure.
How do I make the sandwich? Here we go. There we go. There we go.
What's up? Yes.
How about?
That could be just what we need today.
It could be.
That could be just what we need.
Absolutely. Right. What are we nuking tonight?
Slate sucks. Doesn't mean there's not winners to be found, though, right? A couple plays looking to be funny. What's I like Seattle for this early game. Squad rides is
Clippers.
Part 78. Clippers -6.5. Yep.
Yeah. Okay. But okay. So play in the CBI finals. You guys are on. Sharps are on Seattle.
Yeah. Sharps are on Seattle. I guess Sharps and Bamuel unified on Seattle ML. Love that. Look, I mean, High Point is barely escaping with their fucking lives. They almost folded and blew the game to Arkansas State yesterday. Both these teams are playing back-to-back-to-back days now today, third day in a row. High Point looked gas. Seattle had plenty of energy against Fairfield. They put up a 47-piece in that second half, dominated. Looked like they had plenty of energy. They could have played the championship game right after that game last night. They look ready to roll. Probably why that line flipped. High Point this season, 7-0-1 against the spread as underdogs. That's not going to last. High Point looks free. They've treated bettors great this entire season. Everyone's cashed on High Point. Great story. Great year. But they folded on their home floor in their conference tourney. They weren't able to pull it out. I think the lights will be too bright tonight. I'm going to back Cam Tyson, best player on the floor tonight for Seattle. And the what are they? The Red Wolves? Red Hawks, I believe, is their mascot, Javon. They get it done on the ML tonight. Red Hawks.
Sell job. Beautiful sell job. All right. Seattle with the Sharps.
Yep. See how squad, that plays out. Sharps have been getting mocked.
Squad ride Clippers -6.5.
Yep.
Okay. Any NBA, any other Nuggets? Any Chell Nuggets? No?
Probably not. I'm on the Sens.
You're on the Sens?
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Must do. But POD square, NBA, Dylan Brooks over 1.5 threes against the Thunder.
Can't believe your boy last night hit that three.
I mean, he had two in the first half.
Wow.
Yeah. But Dylan Brooks hitting two in this game. The Thunder, I mean, I don't know if you watched last night, but it's like the same prototype of player, like the three that's going to spot up because they've been a terrible catch and shoot defense. The three that's a little defensive that they kind of want to let shoot absolutely tears them apart and gets a lot of volume. That's why Herb Jones, of all people, shot 8 threes last night and he banked two of them. So like that prototype of player has been destroying the Thunder as they've been gradually getting worse and worse defensively against the catch and shoot, like second half of the season. So like, especially being that Dylan Brooks is probably not going to have to expel nearly as much energy guarding SGA on the other side of the floor today. I like his spot today. So he's going off.
Yeah. Okay. Wait, Herb Jones only made 2 threes.
Yeah. He was 2 for 8.
Jesus, bro. His green gob was 2.5. And I was looking at it. All right. So you got, what's his name? Threes. Dylan Brooks. You got the Clippers, you got Seattle, the Sens. That might be everything that I
now. If you were looking to craft a Fugazi piece, all right, not gonna tell the chef how to cook, but if you were looking to craft one tonight, a Clippers ML and a Seton Hall ML would not be the best look, or would not be the worst look to be getting involved there. I think both those teams win. I love the line movement in that Seton Hall game, up 3.5 points. Maybe somebody's out for UNLV. Maybe it's just weird, sharp movement. I don't know. I don't care. They're winning that game. They are playing like they're trying to prove to the world that they belonged in March Madness, right? That's how they're playing right now. They ain't slowing down, and they're getting 4 points of steam in the NIT. Either something's up that we don't know about, or they're going to win this game by 100. Put them in your parlays tonight, Seton Hall, and I wouldn't mind the Clippers either, but we're taking them on the spread for the squad ride, so that should tell you how confident we are.
Okay. All right. Yeah, Royal, you're right, bro. It was Murphy, not.
Yeah, Trey Murphy was Steph, as always.
How many threes did he have?
I don't know, off the top of the head.
But a lot.
Quite a few.
All right, I hit 4. Damn. Any other questions I had to ask? No.
I've got a nasty prize pick square that's going to hit.
Let me hear it.
It's a less than.
Let me hear it.
Gabe Mattson, less than 14.5 points for Utah tonight. They're playing on their home floor. They've been mucking in the NIT. They're looking like the team that should have made the fucking NCAA tournament at the beginning of the season that was getting hyped up. They're starting to play like it. Gabe Mattson's coming off a fucking career high where he shot 5 for 10, 5 for 11 from 3 in that last contest. Well, Gabe Mattson's got to go against that VCU perimeter defense tonight. And they're not going to give up. They might not win this game, but bless their hearts, they're going to fucking give all the effort they can. And they're going to be absolute gnats on the perimeter playing defense, pressing when they need to. He's not going to go off from 3. Zero chance he has the opportunity to fucking take that many shots from 3. I think he gets strapped up. We fade him after a career high. We take his less than 14.5 points today.
That's surgical. What's his name again?
Gabe Mattson. He's on Gabe Mattson. Coming off a legacy performance.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. W Crabs Nugget.
We're locked today. We got baseball tomorrow. Life is good. No complaints.
Facts, dude. I can't fucking wait.
Cannot wait. Should we run like a mega fucking sweats tomorrow just from Surge?
And
just
we might have to
watch all these baseball games.
We might have to, bro.
We got some of the early games canceled now.
Already? Because of rain?
Yeah.
God.
Yeah, games aren't starting until 2 o'clock with the Halos.
Wow. First game is your Halos. Sure.
Yeah, but it has to be a respectful fade out of respects to Hermo.
Early Orioles run on.
Yep.
100%.
And then the Doyers right after.
Wow, perfect start.
Yeah, okay. Craft a super goat entry. Sweat out the whole day.
Oh my god.
Collab 6-piece, maybe.
There's so many games tomorrow.
A lot.
Yeah, feel free to hop on BTL towards the end if you want to get some shit crafted up for the day games.
Yeah.
Always welcome.
I got my square.
That Devers hog at 11 o'clock is going to hit Diffy. A late game. I love it. What about Vladdy? Where are the Jays at? 3 o'clock against Eflin?
Yeah, against Eflin.
Going to need a base hit from him or else it's kicked.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Kicked.
Any Astros? Yep, 3 o'clock against Nestor. Okay. And then who else in the fucking – oh, Royals? 3 o'clock against Pablo.
Early start.
Yeah, yeah. I think that's everybody. Yeah. Should be a fun one. Oh, Zach fucking Gallen late night. Uh-oh. Mm-hmm.
Nah, he's probably gonna deal.
Get it started early and often.
Not worried about that game.
Dude, I wish he was in Coors to start us off. That'd be
yeah, if he was in Coors, I'd have a little hope, but he's probably gonna dice the Rockies. Leave that. You gotta wait till the next couple games.
Nats are playing the Reds to open this puppy up. We got my guys versus Javon's Milk in Cincy. Just like Ray on the mounds. He's gonna be shaking up there.
It's gonna be a turf.
So nervous.
That over might be oxygen.
There's gonna be offensive squares in that game we need to take.
Yeah, Spencer Steer hit on RBIs going in the slip with Will Benson's bases.
Trent, we're here, brother.
We're fucking here.
You look like a little kid who just saw out in the corner of his eyes the fucking Christmas presents.
Just hearing you say the over in what's the Red Stadium?
Great American Ballpark.
Fuck, I was about to say some shit and I totally forgot. Damn it. Oh, did you see all the new PP categories?
Yeah.
Dude, there's
some home run demons we can play.
Oh my God, dude.
The home run demons is going to be pivotal because we know people get fucking, they get bonkers for the Dinger Tuesday or home run segments on BTLs. People just love betting home run player, right? Everyone loves that. Every single person on earth, even me. And I hate fun when it comes to betting, but yeah, that is massive that they have this up there. We're going to be able to sprinkle those all season. Are you kidding me? Yeah. Prize Picks home run demons? Come on.
You can already see the Super Goats in the popular tab too.
Okay, he's already crafted one. Goods. Honestly, impressive. Good. You pulled that up that quick.
That's a 10x.
Yeah, that should hit, right?
No,
it's gonna hit. Prospect's
gonna make so much coins off of those demon home runs.
Be billionaires. Jorge Polanco, demon home run square. Lock it in.
It's fucking ugly, folks.
Yeah, no.
You have Gallo up there.
I know. They have Gallo over Walk.
Hmm.
He ain't walking.
Probably not.
God damn it, bro. It all starts tomorrow.
Oh, my God. They got this Christian Encarnacion Strand home run demon. Yeah, it's here. I'm taking that. Fuck me.
All right, gents. Friend,
you saw the BTL six-piece MLB season-long mag that we were crafting up earlier?
No, I didn't see the final.
Let me see if I can get it up here.
You have it in front of you or no?
I have the link that I could share, and you could pull it up in the private chat really quick right now. Does that work?
Yeah.
Bang. Chat.
So you'll probably be happy.
Yeah, Vlad is in there. Chats, lock this puppy in. All right, I'm going to put the link as well in the chat for you guys. If you want to tail the BTL six-piece, people forget we smacked this last year. Six pieces don't grow on trees. That's all I'm going to say. Let the results speak for themselves.
Volpe over half a multi?
So half in. Multi. That's the first one we took.
Wow. Yeah. Flaherty over K's. Suzuki home runs. Vlad hits. Abram steals. That got bumped a little bit. That was at 36.
A couple weeks ago. Yep.
Matt Olson unders?
Unders.
Wow.
That's from not mid-major Matt's. He pitched that in the spaces yesterday, and Fat Girls pitched the Seiya play. So we threw those puppies in there, the other four from our brains, and we're going to let it rot. All right.
Wow.
Yeah, the Matt Olson one's crazy. But as soon as Matt was talking about that one yesterday, we could not get that one out of our brains.
Yeah, it's like a Jordan under we had in there last year.
Yeah.
Had to go in.
Wow, great work. I'm tapping in.
Yeah, tail that puppy, will you?
I will.
Yeah, lock in.
Yeah, throw some in there. I'll put the link in chat, so should be good to go. Awesome. All right, boys. Christmas Eve. Come on.
Yes, sir.
Come on. We got games tomorrow, chats. Do not blow your bankrolls today. Responsibly tail the squad ride. Tail whatever Trent crafts up, but keep those coins safe. Big day tomorrow. Sweet 16 MLB. All right, sleep tight. It's literally Christmas Eve.
It is. All right, gents. GGs. Appreciate you.
Yep. We'll be seeing, boys.
Brooks Curry.
We'll be seeing. Yeah, don't nuke the whole bankroll. But with that being said, let's fucking cook up some nukes for the bankroll. Come on. I need a stretch. I need a jewel rip. I need lots of things, boys. I need lots. Oh, wait. Before we go, dude, our guy's back. Turn that cam on, brother. There he is.
Hey, what's up?
What's up, dude? Kilimanjaro, whatever the fucking team name was a Mega Max.
Alajuelense.
Yes.
Yeah, that was a Max. Did you tell it?
I had a small sprinkle on it, and I should have put more on it.
Oh, nice. Well, I tried to DM you. I also had a live nuke on Costa Rica against Argentina. They were Argentina was losing 1-0 at half, and it was plus money to win the game.
Wow.
So I tried to DM you on Twitter so you could nuke it as well.
Damn it, dude. But, I missed that.
Yeah.
Are you Michael Alfaro?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I'm giving you a follow, man. Let's go. All right, now I won't miss it, dude.
Okay, well, for today, we're going back to Costa Rica. This one is a little bit risky of a play. It's Saprissa. This is the main team. This is champion. They actually won the tripit. So they have a lot of players out because they were actually playing with the Costa Rica national team last night. So they are playing against Cartaginés. So in this game, we're going to go both teams to score at minus 110. So Cartaginés hasn't won a game in 2 months. They have not scored a goal in their last three games. So they are more than due to score and to win. This is a team that usually finishes in the top five of the table. They actually won a championship right before Saprissa started winning again. And usually these teams in Costa Rica play their best games when they play against Saprissa. So again, they need a bounce back game. This might be the game. The reason why I'm not going for the money line is because it's Saprissa. So this is the team that usually comes out, you know, this is the team that is supposed to be the champion again. So even with their team, with their B team, they're expected to score. So that's where we're going, both teams to score. And one more thing, Saprissa in their last five games, four out of the last five, both teams have scored in the game.
Okay. All right. Both teams to score, minus 110, Saprissa, Cartaginés.
Correct.
Let's fucking go, dude.
Be seeing.
Be seeing, man. Peace. Peace. Chat, you guys tailing again? Are you guys going to ride? Both teams to score. That's all he's taking. He's not fading either team. What league? Costa Rica. God, you guys are degens, dude. All you fuckers are tailing that shit. You guys need help. No, I mean, I would trust that guy. I would absolutely trust that guy. Nothing wrong with tailing it, but you guys are something else. Look at you degens in chat nuking that shit, bro. W chat today, you guys were on one. How about my Red Tube gang? Didn't give them any love. Let me go peep over at the Red Tube, see what's going on. Red Tube, I see you. 1:30. What's up, boys? I'm gonna start posting daily YouTube videos on the YouTube in the mornings. Is that something you guys would get behind? Just yapping, just nothing more but yappage. But I want to tap into the YouTube gang, bro. W's, W's, W's. Let's go. You guys big YouTubers? No? Chop and Yap? That should just be the name of the show. Chop and Yap. The Morning Yap. That, I love that name. The Morning Yap. All right, let's craft. Let's get some crafting going on. Speaking of yap, I'm yapping. All right, whales. Stay dialed. Last night, dude, yesterday, I was like, fuck everybody. I need a stretch. Let me get a stretch in a song, bro. Can't forget that. I need a song. Let me just go. I haven't even listened to this album yet. I need to. A solid nigga count dog food touch. Moving through the city with your food touch. She ready to suck the gut like a suit touch. You're going against the guys and you're gonna lose touch.
Pray to God it knocks your shoe tight. Shit tight. Check it, Cinderella. Trap off a trap trailer. Blue paper stuck together. That bitch can fuck my bezel. Strapped up with heavy metal. Sip lean, talk to the devil. High ticks, they confidential. AP or presidential. Never go against the ghetto. Stay true, got hoes in Belgium. New bitch, new car is level. I piss codeine on pizza. Free band, you got to get it. Get a check, then flip it in the trenches. And the jets filling up with the benches. Cut a year with buffs, they vintage. Pour AC, the rings on glisten. Real ice, but the bad bitch listen. Ranks on ranks, stuck together. Sit red, talk to the devil. Rosetta Stone forever. High yellow, canary yellow. Hot chocolate, Cinderella. Trap off a trap trailer. Blue paper stuck together. Bad bitch gon' fuck my bezel. You know it's high-rise lows. Two M's, that's on the pedal. This bitch made that bitch jealous. This cup ain't never fellas. My J's, they match your melon. You know it ain't no telling. Rather go duck a felon. The bankroll tuck for bellin'. Blew out what I'm inhaling. This cat's broke out propelling. Back to back like a train. Think twice trying to derail us. Big game like the good fellas. Took our propane propellers. She like go watch go chain. African Cinderella. Mix her in my vanilla. You can find this wherever. Dug in all types of weather. In space looking for better. Rags on right, suck together. Sit red, talk to the devil. Rosetta Stones forever. I yellow, canary yellow. Hot chocolate, Cinderella. Trap off a trap trailer. Blue paper stuck together. Bad bitch gon' fuck my bezel.
I have a whale. I have a whale. Think you guys might buy into it. I need one more leg, though. I come with a whale. But let me find one more. Let me show you what I've got so far, though. Don't know whether to love or hate those words. Chat, listen. I really think today it is indeed, despite the sketchy sell job, I truly believe it's Desmond Bane points tonight. At where is his points? They're not giving us his regular points? No, this is absolutely foul. This is foul. Foul. They don't even have it on Prize Picks. Well, what do we do about that? Potts, you like his points and assists? Do we pivot there? Points and rebounds or points and assists? PA, are we good with that? They don't have his threes either, dude. Points and assists? Before I continue, I need to know if it's his points and assists. No putts today on a day like this is crazy, putts. Putts. All right. We're putting Desmond Bane, PA in here. Desmond Bane, PA. Points and assists. He's probably dropping 30 anyways. I love that. He plays the Lakers. He matches up well against the Lakers. I feel like he's always fucking trying his hardest against the Lakers, bro. But first leg, Desmond Bane, I'm in love with it. I'm in love with it. Next leg, I was thinking, why is the cheat sheet over there? Next leg I'm thinking about is Chet Holmgren points. Is that on Prize Picks yet?
Yes, at 17.5. 17.5 Chet points from who gave me that? Luke. I love that play. Love that. Points for Bane is up. No, you see 24.5. You do on Prize Picks? That's a demon square, brother. Demon square. I want his regular line. But we're taking his points and assists. We're going Chet points. Do you guys like Chet? I thought he had a great sell job on Chet. Not getting W vibes here about Chet, bro. Someone tell me it's a W vibe. Are we not vibing with fucking Chet? I like it. I like it. He's bouncing, or he's having a day. He's having himself a day. All right, next leg, without question, it's got to be Pegula Games. Pegula Games. Bang Pegula. Has to, right? I am shocked no one talked about Jalen Green tonight. I'm shook. But Pegula Games, third leg. So let's put that in the slip. Pegula Games. And then, chat, Torture Chamber. Great point. Great point. That's why you guys are in chat, and that's why I rely on fucking chat. Hartenstein under. Hartenstein under PRA. Adam's got Wales. It's under season. W sell job. The unders have been printing. And I feel like that's got to go in. It's got to go in. Hartenstein under. PRA. Can I get some vibes on that? Hartenstein under. You're not taking the unders. Robinson may work in slowly. I don't know, dude. I feel like it's a good play. It's a slept on play. It's not going to get, it's going to get swept. What's his PRA? Do they take that shit off too? No, it's right here. 21. Did we just get sub whales? 5 gifted subbers? Chet just got bumped to what? Oh my God, right in front of my fucking eyes. It's fine, dude. It's fine. We're taking it still. We take it still. We take it still. I don't care. I don't feel the love from the Hartenstein hunt. But all you have to do is look at this chart and you'll see this shit is going under, bro. That's all you have to see, and I'm putting it in there. Hartenstein under PRA. You know what this chart looks like to me? You know what this chart reminds me of? Siakam RA. It's the exact. His line is low from Mitch Robb's return, though. Yeah, I know. And people are going to look at that and say, holy shit, dude, this is green as ma. It's the same as Hart unders. You guys are talking me off it. Mush, I'm sorry. I'm mid craft sesh, and I didn't mean to be disrespectful. W sub whales from Mush, dude. Burn! It's good. Wins the game at the buzzer. Burn! Is the Super Bowl. There you go. There you go. There you go. We're going Isaiah under. Desmond Bang, Chet, Pegula Games, Hartenstein under. Yeah, true, dude. Do we want to get fucked by Thibodeau again? Whole game because he's coming back from big injury and they need him in the playoffs. Hartenstein will probably pay more than you think. God, you guys are you're talking me off this play. I wish Adams Wales was in chat to back me up here.
I was also thinking Nick Richards under RA. Nick Richards under RA is what I had as this five legger. Are we in for that at least? Are we in for the Nick Richards under? All right, I'm in on those, on the Nick Richards under. What about Justin Halkey's Janoe hits? Janoe hits. I don't know, dude. McAvoy hits from Uncle Rito. What about Vito? Hold on. Kawhi three-pointers. Uncle fucking Vito. That could be the play. The only reason I'm not putting Dylan Brooks in here is because we already have Chet, and I'm not trying to double down. But hold on. We could go Kawhi threes from Vito. 1.5 threes. I'm in. I'm in. It looks gross, dude. I love it. I love it. Let's do that. Kawhi three-pointers. Kawhi threes, Desmond points, Chet points, Pegula games. That's four I'm married to. I'm married to those four. We're not changing it. We need two more. Chet, D-Bane, Kawhi, Pegula is a 4-0 card. Here we go. There he is. Take Hartenstein and move on. Chat will give a million reasons, but they didn't give the play. I did, and I stand by it. Mitch will play 10 to 15 minutes, and Hartenstein will play 25 tops in what should be a massive blowout game. I'm 10-4 on Surge Stream this month. I don't give dooms. I give booms. Man, how do you not take this play? How do you not take it, dude? Adam's got whales. You guys talked me off this play yesterday. Shit was green as Ma in the first quarter. You're talking me off this play today. He feels disrespected. And with that, I'm putting it in. I think I'm looking at a six-man gobbler right here. Kawhi, D-Bane, Chet, Pegula, Hartenstein, Nick Richards. How are the vibes shit right now, dude? I'm literally mid-craft. How are my vibes shit right now, dude? Like, what? All right, let's look. Let's look at this. Let's see how this looks on the eyeballs. On the eyeballs, okay? You got three overs in the NBA, two unders in the NBA, and a tennis play that needs to hit. I feel like with ASIM, bro, we have such a little secret system that nobody else on Twitter is able to utilize unless they watch the show. The background? What do you mean, Kels? You don't like the fucking background? You don't like the background, dude? All right, tennis. We kind of worked to put this together, and you don't like it, Kels? The fuck? All right, how does it look on the eyeballs? Kels just bitching, dude. Like, what? How does this look on the fucking eyeballs, boys? It looks like a winner. If ASIM does his job, dude, I truly think this is a 6 out of 6.
Every square has a story. Desmond bang me home points. Is this one in LA or Memphis? I think it's in Memphis. Damn, bro. Nick Richards trap potential. Today is Pagula's dad's birthday. She's wrapping this shit up for her dad. I don't know if that's a good thing, Jeremy Perry. I don't know if that's a good thing. Because we need that to go over games. But yeah, it's in Memphis. Short spread. Hartenstein going to have 20 boards today. Chat's going to bitch about every under and then bitch about not being any unders in the slip. It's every time. But this is part of my job is to just shut everybody up. I know I've been absolutely horrible at this shit lately, but you got to just get up and move on. You got to get up and move on, get back in the lab, craft up a whale, and this is what I've got. Just do me, all right? We've got Pagula Games, Nick Richards under, running back banker better. It's under season. Hartenstein under. Adam's got Wales, has life online for this. And then you go Kawhi three-pointers. Uncle Vito is surgical as Ma. Chet Holmgren with no Shea. Yes, please. And Desmond bang me home. It looks good as fuck. I love it, dude. I love it. Lock it in. Let's lock it in. But the volume's not there. Listen, dude, I truly think that Kawhi comes out pissed off tonight. And he can hit this in the first quarter, bro. It's Kawhi Leonard. It's Kawhi fucking Leonard. List? You want the list? Here's the list. All right, let's get my three straight bets of the day. Let me lock in this prize pick slip, though. How much coin am I putting on this? Let's go 500. A respectable 500. We're in. It's locked. I was so locked on my straight bets last night, chat. Here's the entry if you want a tail. All right, straight bets. What's your DM, Adam? Adam, that actually is a winning four geyser. I'm not joking. Chat, this is a winning four geyser, man, from Adam's Got Wales. If you want that. Jamal Murray slept on. All right. Let's go to the graphic. W Adam's Got Whale graphic. Pretty fire graphic. Not going to lie. Hartenstein under, Claxton more than boards. W graphic from Adam's Got Wales. All right. Back to the straights. What am I nuking today, boys? What am I nuking? Give me a second here. Let me dial in. I need some whales. Let's start with a Fugazi, bro. I might not need an extended lab work for straight bets. Fugazi, clips. I really do think the Thunder are going to win tonight, chat. Did we put them in? I say we put them in, bro. Put them in. Nah, I feel like I get flamed everywhere if I put them in. I put them in every time. I put them in every fucking time. Let them play. How about the Orlando Magic? I'm in on that. Fade the fuck out of the Warriors on a back-to-back. I'm in. Play the song. What's the line on that Seton Hall game? It won't show me. 5.5 Seton Hall money line. What's the money line? Minus 270. How about one hockey play? Bolts ML. Are we going Bolts? Or is it no Bolts? Is it the Sens? I might straight bet the Senators. Kels, are you on the Bees tonight? The Bolts are boosted. Okay. Yeah, I mean, hockey's kind of sketch, dude. I'm on don't touch that game tonight. Okay. But you're on the Sens. Yeah, I might leave hockey out of this. Hockey sold me last night for some megas. So hard. I think we got to go to the OKC Thunder, bro. They're too good at home. They're too good at home. Nuggets in Seattle. That kind of looks good. That kind of looks good. Clippers, Magic, Thunder, Nuggets, Seattle. I'm down to take the Thunder out and go with something else. Do we go Seton Hall? Seton Hall? Yeah, let's do it. I need a minus 270 placeholder, though, to show me what the odds are. Give me a minus 270 somewhere. The Nuggets are already that. Oh, Seattle starts in an hour? Fuck that. Fuck that. I'm going to straight bet that secretly. God damn it. Clippers, Magic, Nuggets. W sub bangs. W Richie Rich with a couple sub bangs. Choose Rich, bro. Yeah, I'm going with the Thunder. Fuck it. Seton Hall, last leg. Seton Hall, last legger. Yeah. Minus 250, Seton Hall. So what would the odds be for this parlay? Plus 550. That works. That works. I'm doing it. Sorry, boys. I see you in chat bitching about Seton Hall. I'm taking them. We send it to graphics guy. Boom. That'll pay. That'll pay. That'll pay. All right. I'm going to go craft my six or my three straight bets. Cause I don't know exactly what it is I want to nuke, and I want to run it back and be surgical and not force some shit. So, that's my plan. I'm going to post the plays as soon as I get off. W stream today, chat. Let's move and groove and bring the coins home tonight. Night sweats later. We got a big NBA slate tonight. If you want to tail my prize picks entry that I just put $500 on, here's the link right here. God, dude, it looks good. It looks good. It doesn't look forced. If Pegula goes over games, we're winning coin. I feel it. I feel it. I really do. Fugazi's, Clippers, Thunder, Nuggets, Magic, Seton Hall. And I'm posting three straight bets. They're all going to smack, and we're putting the bookie in piss. That's the plan. Fugazi's probably cooked. It's only a one-unit bet. Skywalker. Chat, best of luck tonight. I'll see you guys in a little bit. We will indeed be seeing Rizzy Raids. Chewy's live. Yeah, I heard Chewy yesterday. Book of Chew. Book of Chew Sports. All right, chat. Much love. We'll be seeing. W Goat Whale Bit. I'm literally about to post that, Skywalker. Who made that, Skywalker?